SEC on CBS. And it brings us to Tuscaloosa, Alabama, at a matchup. The first home SEC game for the number two Crimson Tide of Alabama, taking on the Rebels of Ole Miss. And here comes the Tide. Everybody, Brad Nessler along with Gary Danielson, our first trip into Tuscaloosa this year, the home SEC West opener for the Tide, and we look at the first month of the season, Gary, and we go, well, figured Alabama is going to be right about here at 4-0, but the rest of the conference doesn't look too bad either.
Yeah, Alabama and Georgia, we kind of knew those guys, and I think the surprise in this conference has been LSU number one. I mean, Joe Burrow and that team, and then Auburn. You know, right. I mean, they knew we had a tough schedule. And don't sleep on Florida. Dan Mullen always seems to find a way to get in the mix.
Tua Tagovailoa off to a sensational start this year. 17 yeah. touchdown passes, no interceptions. We know he's got maybe the greatest group of receivers in college football. What about the other things they have to start to do?
Yeah, you know, sometimes it's so mesmerizing. You know, you watch the ball, you watch the receivers. But, you know, Alabama fans, and we know, if they want to get to where they want to go, they want to win the championship, the rest of the team has to come through. Let's start looking at a few other things in this football game that need to get better. Najee Harris has started to come out of it. We saw it, you know, start to make those big plays that they're looking for. One more running back. We know when Alabama has been good, they've had two, and Brian Robinson needs to step up. Nick Saban is concerned. The offensive line can provide pass protection, but if he needs two or three first downs from that offensive line, can they produce it when they have to? And then with the injuries to the inside linebackers, you got two young, true freshmen, Harrison Lee. Those three spots have to come through for Alabama to get to play for the championship. Yep. It's not just any one game. It's measured with championships.
Ole Miss comes in 2-2 up until yesterday when we talked to the coaches. The quarterback situation for them is pretty murky. About 2 hours ago, it got officially cleared up. Jamie's got more on that.
It did. An official word came down that it is the true freshman, John Rhys Plumlee, who will make the start at quarterback today for Ole Miss. Matt Loop told us before the game that Matt Corral, who suffered an injury in last week's game to his ribs, didn't take a single snap at practice all week. He was hoping he could warm up today and be an emergency option for Ole Miss, but he is in gym shorts and no pads on the sideline now. As far as Plumlee goes, Matt Loop told us that he is a unique kid who has a lot of confidence in his abilities, and guys, he is going to need it today to not only beat the Heat, but this Alabama defense.
So, Garrett, for the second time, we have a true freshman quarterback having to play against Alabama.
Yeah, you grew up in Minnesota, right? Remember, your parents just say, all right, the water's cold, you're going to go into the lake, just jump in. And that's what Plumlee has to do. He's going to go into the SEC, but he's going to jump into the cold water of having to play this Alabama defense. There's no hiding here, but he is uniquely skilled. You watch him, he's probably a 4-4 runner, and he's going to have to use all of his talents to keep this Alabama defense off balance.
Well, speaking of cold water, I hope everybody in the stands has some. It's
don't
a warm day.
Toe in, jump in.
Might be a record-setting temperature day. It's 91 right now. Feels like it's over 100. Ole Miss won the toss and will defer. Series history, 53-11-2. The only loss at home for Alabama in the last 6 years was to Ole Miss 4 years ago. Alabama will get the football first. And we're underway. Short kick. Taken. Brian Robinson at about the 8. Reads his way across the 25. Nice return almost to the 28-yard line. As we take a look at the Chick-fil-A starting lineups, it all starts with number 13. We already mentioned Tua Tagovailoa. 78% of his passes, 17 touchdowns, no interceptions, and he's one shy of the school record for career total touchdowns, including on the ground, 79 right now. And the rest of the Alabama offense. We talk so much about their receivers, Judy and Smith and Waddle, and right now Henry Ruggs has become the home run hitter. 148 career high yards a week ago and 2 touchdowns in their win over Southern Miss. He's got a lot of tools to work with. Tua does. And he's all by himself in the Alabama backfield. Stands at the 5-yard line. Was blocked in the back on the kickoff. That's why they start where they do. Quick slant. Quick throw, Jerry Judy. out to the 18-yard line as we'll set the defense for you for the Rebels of Ole Miss. Jacquez Jones, an inside linebacker, is a Tuscaloosa native, and you know he'd love to have a big game here in his hometown. Najee Harris has the first down, quite a bit more, out to the 26. There's who Gary was talking about in the open. Najee Harris starting to warm up as a running back.
And what does he do? Follow one of those big offensive line. Watch the kick out by Evan Neal right here coming across. Boom, kick it out. Just follow the net. Brad, as we saw in practice, is a big man.
He is monstrous. 6'7", 360 pounds, somewhere in there.
The lowest body fat on the offensive line, if you can believe that.
Out of the pistol set, it will play fake to Harris. Tua throws late and incomplete, intended for Forrestall, the tight end. Kadir Shepherd got a little heat on the Alabama quarterback. It'll bring up second down and 10.
Some new defensive coordinator Mike McIntyre for Ole Miss has been preaching to his team all week. Keep it in front of you, but close the space. If you give them too much space, they'll make you look foolish. So yes, in front, and if you look at in the box where the brain trust is, but keep them close, but in front, just like that.
And to the races goes Devontae Smith. He will cruise to the end zone. 74 yards, touchdown, Alabama.
So, Ness, there's one more step. Keep him in front of you, keep him close, and then make the tackle.
And they didn't do the last part.
Keep him in front of you, keep him close. You know they're going to close slants. They've been doing them all year. And then wrap up the tackle. Practice it all week, and first one, and basically second slant of the day goes to the house.
Bulovas to attempt the point after. And it's up and good. So it only took 70 seconds for Alabama to go 90 yards in four plays. And Tua Tagovailoa now has tied that mark of A.J. McCarey. His 18th touchdown toss of the year. Right on the money to number six. And Devontae says, I'm going to take this one all the way to the end zone. 7-0, Alabama. They'll investigate the unexplainable evil. CBS original series Thursday at 10, 9 central on CBS. And take Alabama long for Devontae Smith to score the first touchdown, his fourth receiving touchdown of the year.
And we went away, you know, just thinking about Matt Luke on the sideline, what he's got to be selling to his team.
Ball of his kick, returnable. Jerry Ealy. He's only taken one for a score this year. He's not even going to make the 16-yard line in this case, though. Let's take you back to the touchdown. An RPO, Gary, could have been an RIP, like rest in peace.
Sure was. Chris Owens, the center this time. Watch him get almost 2 to 3 yards. You're allowed to go 3 yards. The offensive line is blocking a run play. Najee Harris doesn't know if he's going to get the ball or not. Only the quarterback. When the ball is released, the center is about 2.5 yards downfield. But that linebacker has to play it honest. And Jalen Julius, number 26, has to help out the defense by making the tackle.
The freshman quarterback gives it off for a 2-yard gain to Scotty Phillips. As we take a look at the Chick-fil-A starting lineups, and it starts with number 10, John Rhys Plumlee. True freshman out of Hattiesburg, Mississippi. 7 for 7 for 82 yards last week in what was a comeback attempt against Cal. They came up short 28-20 in that game. And he's going to run it. This time, puts his shoulder into the defender, got it out to the 21, maybe the 22-yard line as we check the rest of the offense. They're going to need some big plays today, and the guy that supplied them so far has been Elijah Moore. Comes in as their leading receiver. Ole Miss 37% on third down conversion so far through the first month. They won't have a chance here as Terrell Lewis knocks it down.
He was questionable. He didn't practice on Thursday, but he makes the first big play today.
And he's about 6'5", 6'6", probably has a reach to 8 feet. And when he jumps, he's probably 9 feet, 9.5 feet. Try to throw the slant. Let's put it this way. John Rice didn't see anybody in high school last year like that at all.
I don't think so. Jalen Waddle waiting on the punt from Mack Brown. Waddle's going to have a chance at this one from the 36. He dropped it. Picked up on the fly by Ole Miss. And they're going to score. Touchdown. A.J. Finley. You knew Ole Miss was going to have to make some kind of special plays to stay with Alabama. That couldn't be more special.
Well, remember when they beat him last time here, Alabama turned the ball over five times in that football game. None any uglier than this. You got one of your best players juggling and bouncing. It bounces off of a helmet and into the hands of Ole Miss. Remember, there was a play in that game where a pass was a bad snap and it bounced off a few Alabama players for a touchdown on a touchdown pass. Very reminiscent of that play right there.
I looked up, that ball's in the air and somebody else grabbed it. So.
I remember he's got the land shark chain over there.
Yes. Remember Chad Kelly in that game caught a wild snap, threw it up at the last second, got a touchdown. Just reminiscent of that play right there.
Review of the play. Now checking to see if it's a fumble or a muff, I guess. Gerald Hodges, our replay official.
There must be a difference between the two that make maybe it can't be advanced if it's one of the two differences.
Ken Williamson is on the headset. Our rules expert Gene Steratore is with us. Gene, welcome to Tuscaloosa.
That is what they're looking at, Brad. Welcome. It's good to hear from you guys early. What they are reviewing right now is when that kick begins. This receiver from Alabama must gain possession for the kick to officially end. Here we can see he just bobbles this through the whole process, which makes that an extension of the kick. A kick cannot be advanced by the kicking team, so what they will do now is go to replay, in my opinion, and go back to right here where the ball is possessed by the kicking team and give Ole Miss the ball at the 30-yard line because it is a muffed kick that cannot be advanced.
Gene? Have a beer on me for helping us out.
The ball was not possessed, but rather muffed. Therefore, the Ole Miss's ball, first down at the 30-yard line on the right hash. Please adjust the clock. 12 minutes and 50 seconds. 12:50.
It appears that if it would have been a fumble, though, it could have been repaired for a touchdown. Great job by everyone involved, the replay official here. Great job by us not knowing what is going on, and then bringing in Gene.
Anyway, it's Ole Miss ball. After all of that, would have been a 30-yard touchdown, so take that off the board. Still a nice play by A.J. Finley. So Plumlee's got the offense right there at the 30-yard line. Still a golden opportunity here early. Fakes the pitch. He's going to run it himself. Trying to get outside and does. And there he shows some of that speed that Jamie was talking about in the open. He's got a first down.
Well, Pete Golding, defensive coordinator for Alabama, first-year defensive coordinator, actually recruited John Rice to come to Alabama.
As a safety.
But what he said, he's an excellent high-end athlete.
This time he boxes it outside and won't get much. Although he did kind of keep his balance and put his hand out. Let's see where they spot this.
He gained a lot of yards on that play. His athletic ability.
Here's the Alabama defense. Terrell Lewis, as I said, was questionable. He's already made a big play on the previous series. So he helps that linebacking core that has so much youth that Gary talked about. Pistol set here. Give it to Phillips. Fighting for yardage. He might have gotten a couple. There's the flashback from the win. Gary was talking about last time Alabama lost at home. Crazy plays.
If I'm calling plays, if I'm Rich Rodriguez, I'm thinking I've got four downs, so I've got two downs to pick this up.
Plumlee's going to run it. He's got the first down, and he's down in inside the five.
Huge underdog in this football game. You have an opportunity to steal a score in this situation. What I'm thinking if I'm Rich Rodriguez is I'll call this play. If I don't get it, nice cutback that time by John Rice. If I don't get it, I got another call right after it on fourth down. Rich Rodriguez needs to find Plumlee some help. Where else can he find help in the running game?
First and goal inside the five. Sky Phillips driving. And he's down around the one-yard line. Raekwon Davis, big number 99, is on the bottom of the pile. Nice job to run through that traffic to get what he got. Second and goal. Snoop Connors in there with Phillips. Dual backfield, straight ahead. Just shy of the goal line. It'll be third down and goal. About a foot out.
Against Cal, Matt Corral was the quarterback. Had a situation just like this, and the quarterback, Matt, kept it and just walked into the end zone. Let's see if they run the crisscross play again and just let him keep it.
Plumlee will keep it, and he'll walk in as Gary called it. Touchdown, Ole Miss.
Same play against Cal. They ran it to the right. This time they run it to the left, get outflanked, and walk in. Matt Luke, 5 minutes ago, was yelling at his team to stay in the game. Now he's yelling at his team, I told you.
He's going to blow a hamstring if he doesn't calm down over there. Extra point is up and good. 10:20 to go in the first quarter. Jaylen Waddle. The muffed punt at the 30-yard line, recovered by Ole Miss. It took them 7 plays, 2.5 minutes to draw even with the Tide. Here was the play. Recovered right there by A.J. Finley. 7 plays later, the freshman quarterback does it himself from a yard out. 7-7. Rich Rodriguez says, yeah, baby. Stream CBS Sports HQ, the free 24/7 news network for coverage that's always focused on the game. Get nonstop highlights, fantasy advice, and picks. Download the CBS Sports app to watch today. Spencer Cole to kick off for Ole Miss. Really short kick at about the 21 as Trayvon Diggs. And Diggs got out to the 30. Tie game here. Against Ole Miss, those past 5 years, how about that? The rest of the SEC hasn't fared very well.
Right.
Alabama going for their 28th straight home win today. And they have won 86 in a row against unranked teams. And Ole Miss is not ranked, but so far doing good here in the first quarter. Remember, a year ago, Ole Miss scored the first touchdown, and then 62 points later, it
first
was
play of the game.
62-7. Play fake to the top of the lower. Going to go deep. Flag down. Jerry Jeudy, the intended receiver. And it's either going to be holding or pass interference. At least I thought I saw a flag fly in.
Well, Jerry Jeudy felt like he could have gotten to the ball if he wasn't tugged on the play. And do you doubt him?
Not really.
There's again, it was Jalen Julius. Remember, they ran a slant on him for a touchdown last time. Now they go
pass
deep.
Interference.
On.
Defense number 26. The penalty is 15 yards. The previous spot includes an automatic first down.
You know, 15 yards isn't bad, consider what that could have been.
Well, how smart of a call is that by Steve Sarkisian? Okay, last play, they beat him for a slant for a touchdown. So he comes right back at him, the pressure point, and makes 26 defend the deep ball.
There's Steve Sarkisian, offensive coordinator, on the sideline. So with the 15-yard walk-off, Alabama at the 45. Najee Harris threw a big hole on the left side. Got out across the 50 into the 49 of Ole Miss.
Yeah, they just mash it down this time. Left tackle Leatherwood and Neal. They just smash it down to the side and just run it right off tackle. And then Leatherwood comes off on the backside linebacker.
Quickly, Alabama on second down. Najee got stood up and put down after a short game, maybe a yard. Kadir Shepherd in on the stop. Najee Harris coming off a 110-yard game on 14 carries a week ago.
understand what defensive coordinator, first-year defensive coordinator Mike McIntyre is trying to bring to this Ole Miss team. They were gutted by rushing almost pick your poison last year. He's convinced this team, we have to defend the rush first, and then we'll figure out how to stop the pass. It's not easy to do when you're playing against this Alabama team.
They only give up a little over 100 yards a game on the ground, and a bad game in their opener. Last three have been better. Tagovailoa all day to throw. Down the pipe, Judy, first down, Alabama. At the 37.
Well, again, we talked about that offensive line. The feature today, can they keep it clean? Just a three-man rusher. They should keep a good pocket, and they do when you give the quarterback that much time.
That was Henry Ruggs, beg your pardon, on number 11 making the catch.
Well, you probably saw the rock, paper, scissors the wrong way that time.
Got to work on that.
Got to work on that. You didn't see it very clear. We'll get to that.
Here's some heat on Tagovailoa for the first time, and down he goes. 13th sack of the year for the Landshark defense, and Benito Jones is the guy that got to Tua.
Yeah, but Kadir Shepherd, number 97 that time, coming off the edge, blew up the play. Watch it come right across the edge right here and just blow up the play through two blockers, and that forced Tua out of the pocket. Najee was not able to help at all, and you got somebody, you know, coming that fast, it's going to blow it up.
And that was the guy that caught the previous pass, Henry Ruggs. He's down here on the bottom of the screen. He started limping right off the bat.
That's exactly right.
Oof. Well, that takes away one of their home run hitters, at least for the time being. We'll try to check on Henry when we come back. Henry Ruggs being helped off the field and into the tent. Guy that's averaging almost 22 yards a catch. We take you back two plays ago.
It appears innocent. You don't see anything. It looks like 100 different plays, right?
Right.
But something with his left leg that time.
And then the play where he was injured, he wasn't touched, but the leg gave out on takeoff.
You can see when he gets up here, he knows something's wrong, but he tries to play one more play and he can't go.
John Metchie, a freshman, is going to be in there when they're four wide set with runs out, and he's in there right now. Pumps once and then throws late. Completes it, Devontae Smith.
Has a great job by Devontae Smith that time. Even though Tua has to pump, Devontae never stops coming back to the quarterback. He never stalls, so he gives the quarterback an easy throw for a completion.
And the tie going quickly. Here's a flare out to Najee Harris. Nice play defensively out there to get around the would-be block of Devontae Smith and then make the tackle as Sam Williams.
Yeah, when we talk to defensive coordinator Coach McIntyre, he said Sam Williams is going to be a great player when he learns how to figure it out. Looks like he's figuring out fights right through a block that time off the edge. Well, it is a wide receiver block him, and he refused to get blocked.
Sam's a Montgomery, Alabama native, oddly enough, played high school football with Henry Ruggs, who's in the Alabama tent right now.
It would be about a 54-yard field goal if Alabama wanted to go for it.
False start. Offense number 69. 5-yard penalty. Remains fourth down.
And to Dickerson.
Now it would be a punt.
And that means Skylar DeLong will come out to punt.
I mean, a Rebel fan, after the way of that shocking start, has to feel unbelievably good about where their team is right now, right at this point.
Elijah Moore waiting on the kick. It's partially blocked, or did he,
no, he did
just
that,
hit it that way?
Yeah, that back upside, you know, backward kick where it goes end over end, and he did not hit it very well.
Gotcha. And Henry Ruggs on that catch, and then the play after that on his takeoff. He got about 6 yards out and pulled up lame. Jamie?
Well, here's the official word from Alabama. Lower body injury, questionable to return. He could put no weight on that left leg, but he was standing on that left foot by the time he got in the tent.
All right, Jamie, thanks. Scotty Phillips, nice run before he runs into Xavier McKinney. They're going to need some more of that, and he is their leading rusher. Scotty, kind of one of the surprises. The running back area in the SEC a year ago had over 900 yards on the ground. Right now he's in a slot on the left side with Plumlee all by himself. And the Ole Miss backfield. It's a quarterback run all the way. And he got about three.
You know, I talked to Coach Rodriguez about Plumlee and how much he's going to run him. He says, "Well, we've got to go fast, and the offense demands the quarterback runs the ball. And it's just the way we're going to run it. We have to do it. That's our offense."
Here's a long ball for the first time, and a diving catch down at the 35-yard line. Elijah Moore, we said he would have to be a big play guy today. There's his first big one.
I mean, to adjust the ball, he's looking over his right shoulder, then he flips around and handles the ball. There's a lot of guys that just cannot lose the football in the air and find it like that. What a play.
Phillips for about a yard.
Also like the call for a young quarterback to throw the ball to the outside. Not a lot of stuff to think about. Just let it go, and they hurried up, and it was the correct call.
Elijah Moore's 30th catch of the year. I don't think any of the previous 29 were that good. Here's a quick slant the other way and knocked down nicely by Trayvon Diggs. And there's a flag down.
It's interesting formation that time. Ole Miss flanks four receivers.
Offside. Defense number two. 5-yard penalty. Remains second down.
Patrick Surtain is taught to jam the one-up player right here. And he gets called on it.
Oh,
he was just a bit early on the play.
He did it right in front of the headlines.
Exactly.
Couldn't miss that one.
And the Alabama bench said, "Patrick, we'd like to help you, but we can't help you."
Second down and four at the 29. This one is Snoop Connor for a couple.
The advice that Rich Rodriguez, who's got a lot of experience with running quarterbacks, is you think touchdown, first down, get down as a quarterback.
Here's Connor again. He might have a first down. Freshman 215-pounder. They use him in short yardage or in that dual backfield set that he was in that time.
Very effective.
And they move the sticks. Matt Luke's got to be loving what he's seeing right now.
Eating up a little clock, moving the ball again. He's got three different players in the backfield that can run the ball.
First down at the Alabama 25. Plumlee pulls it out, rolls out, and then runs out after about a 6-yard gain. John Rhys Plumlee, freshman, committed to Georgia. Now he's at Ole Miss. He's a really good baseball player. Probably will start in the outfield. And plays piano for fun, and we saw him doing a little bit of that.
And Christopher Allen at time is going to vote that, yes, I can tell you this guy's fast, because he outran me to the sideline.
At the 17, quick throw to the outside. It'll be close to a first down, depending on where the linesman spots it. I think he's just a little bit short.
You know, the fans do not have the luxury that we have, Brad, to come to these teams' practice on Thursday. But one of the fun guys to watch practice every day, and we've been watching him for 4 years, Xavier McKinney, number 15. What a great football player he is.
Here's a first down run by Plumlee as he somersaults his way inside the 15.
So the advice again for the quarterback. Touchdown right there, no. But he's got to make the first down. You know, son, we don't want you to get hurt. But when you got a chance to make a first down for the team, you got to take it. And he ran it, he accelerated, and he did it. These young freshman quarterbacks don't seem to be in awe of anything anymore, do they?
No, they aren't. There's Connor to the 10.
So the difficulty for Alabama here, it is basically a three-man running backfield that Ole Miss is using right here. It's, you know, a little bit single wing, a little bit wishbone, but they are crisscrossing and going every direction. Very difficult to stop.
Alabama trying to bring some run pressure, and it works. The big guys inside led by Anthony Jennings from the linebacker corps. DJ Dale was there as well.
Let's see this situation now. If Alabama might try to bring pressure, if you do, you have to pressure the quarterback as if he's a receiver. Pete Golding, do you come after the quarterback? And if you're Ole Miss, are you going to let him throw here?
We're going to find out. Third down and 8 at the 12. They empty the backfield. Plumlee, quarterback draw, and whistle blew before he took off, and a flag down.
False start. Offense, number 11. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
Ontario Drummond, a wide receiver, with a false start.
also in this situation. Not only do they have a true freshman quarterback, but left tackle in the rotation, Nick Broker's in there as well, number 64. So your blindside tackle is also a true freshman.
Even if they only get a field goal attempt, they would like to get some more yardage for their field goal kicker. And Plumlee got about two of it back.
That's what I thought Pete Golding would do. Come off the edge, five-man rush that time, and go at that quarterback.
And Matt Luke thought there was a face mask on the play.
Let's take a pick. Coming right off both edges that time. Five-man rush. Did not see much of it.
Nope.
There's new first-year defensive coordinator, Pete Golding. Had a great visit with him yesterday.
Luke Logan, I mentioned. His career long is 40. His longest this year is 35. This will be from 33. They try to give the Rebels the lead on the Tide's turf. Up and good. Got it. So surprise, surprise. Unranked. Ole Miss. First time Alabama's trailed all year. They're down three. I was wondering when the last time Alabama trailed at home. Our gang in the truck brought it up quickly for us. How about that? 3 years ago against Auburn. Spencer Cole to kick off.
Another pooch.
This one is a live ball. Who's on top of it? Alabama got it, but it was close.
You know, that seems to be worth it to me. I mean, if you could give the other team the ball on the 30-31-yard line and have a chance for an onside play, that's better than giving them the chance for a return ball or the ball going to the 25. I like that call. Very good execution of the pooch here. And this, you know, these are not an easy recovery right here.
Jalen Moody is the guy that did recover it. And he didn't even see where that was until it bounced in front of him. So Alabama playing from behind. Brian Robinson behind Tua Tagovailoa. As Ole Miss has run twice as many plays as the Alabama offense. It's Robinson. He broke in to the next level. He's still going. And a first down. 12 yards or more for Brian Robinson.
So he follows transfer Landon Dickinson, number 69 that time. Right guard pulls, tight end pulls around for a stall, and Robinson breaks a couple tackles and makes a play.
Got an Ole Miss player down, Patrick Lucas, I think, the nose tackle. It is. Backup nose tackle, a freshman. Alabama native as well. .222 remaining in the first quarter with Ole Miss on the road leading by a field goal. Patrick Lucas in the Ole Miss injury tent as he walked off under his own power back on the field. Alabama has a first down at its own 46-yard line. Brian Robinson again. And again, Brian Robinson into the secondary might have another first down. Back-to-back big-time runs by number 24.
Tell you that time, Evan Neal, number 73, comes around and kicks out again. Watch him kick it out real easy and just get it downfield. No one touches anybody until about 7 yards downfield.
Robinson stays in there, the tailback spot. Another Alabama first down, this time at the 44-yard line of Ole Miss. The final couple minutes, quarter number one. Getting big chunks on every play. Forrestall, the tight end, in motion. Play action to a Tagovailoa. Down the middle, and he's got Judy. And another first down for the Tide.
Play action pass, 101 NFL style. You see it everywhere on Sundays. You get a play action pass, the slot goes across, and you bring the right behind him, the square end, throw it off the linebacker. That's the way they teach it. That's the way they perfectly execute it.
You drew that one pretty well, too. You had it right on those guys.
Well, that was like the first play you put in, basically.
First down at the 27. Arnold coming over in the slot. Sets up shop there. Devontae Smith on a little toss from Tua. Looking for blockers. Smith, a hurdle. A first down inside the 20.
Well, that time, actually, that counts as a pass play. Noah Forrestall, number 87. Watch him get out in front of it right here. Fowler behind. Oh, geez, at that time, Jedrick Willis, number 74, just punished his guy full run as well. We've seen this offensive line that has been challenged to be more physical. They're answering the bell so far in the game.
Yeah, they sure are. Back in the red zone for the Tide. They're going to regain the lead at the Ole Miss 17. For Judy to end up about where he started. Jalen Julius was one of the first guys that just hung with him until he got help.
Well, at the end of a first quarter like this, you probably take it to the end of it. Not a bad football game.
Thank you. That guy's maybe not too happy about it, but.
Will he get another playoff or not? I think he's just faking it out.
And here we go. He'll run it down to the end of the quarter. A good one for Ole Miss, man, on the road, leading number 2 Alabama 10-7 at the end of the first quarter. We'll return to Tuscaloosa after this message and a word from your local station. To go at the Ole Miss 17-yard line. Ole Miss in front by a field goal. Forrestall, the tight end. Switches spots from right to left.
He does know he's going to get pressure off the edge right here, but nope. Ole Miss checks out of it.
They back out of it. Tagovailoa. The play fake. The throw. Inside the 5 goes Judy. And it's going to be first and goal, Alabama. Brad Nessler, Gary Danielson, Jamie Erdahl. You know, you and I do so many Alabama games where we go, how can the other team get back into it, whoever that other team might be? They're not only in it, they're leading.
Well, they got a break. But more importantly for Ole Miss, they took advantage of the break. You know, a lot of times you get a turnover and you can't do anything right with it. They stuck in the end zone.
That's what Alabama is trying to do right now. The throw out in the flat to Waddle. Waddle, did he get there? Flags fly in at the end. It's a touchdown. Again, penalty marker on the play, so we'll wait and see.
Get the ball to one of their playmakers. Remember, you can block at the line of scrimmage if the ball is completed.
Holding on the offense, number 4. 10-yard penalty for previous spot. Repeat first down.
Jerry Judy with the penalty. It's funny, the wide receivers had an argument the other day at practice about who's the best blocker of the 4 or 5 of them are, and this one's not a good block.
And there's Judy right there. You can block before the ball is thrown. You can't hold anytime, whether it's before the throw or after the throw, and he got called on the play.
He tried to put his hands up as if to say, I didn't do anything.
You
there you
go.
He's
got a whole handful of jersey there. Center of attention is Jalen Julius, no matter what, so far.
Seems like it, right?
Yep.
So back at the 15, where it's first to go. Brian Robinson.
Nice
broke a tackle. And another. And Robinson with maybe his best day so far this year.
That's the cut you're looking for the running back to Alabama to make. The line's going to block it okay, but you got to make a move. There it is. Make one guy miss in the hole. That's why we recruited the running backs here at Alabama. At the point of attack, you got to make somebody miss, and he did. That's a wonderful play by Brian Robinson.
Yeah, Jack West Jones is still wondering where he
yes,
was.
Yes.
The second down, a goal as he got it back to the 7. 2 tight ends set for the Tide here. Bootleg. Tagovailoa pumps once. He's going to run it himself, and he'll score. Tua Tagovailoa. Touchdown, Alabama.
Wanted to slide the ball into the flat that time. It wasn't there. He thought about throwing back across his body to the tight end Forrestall, but he says, nope, not going to make that mistake. But then he gets tagged in the end zone that time. Big time tag by Kai Henry, number 1.
So Joseph Bulamis in for the point after.
Brad, then he forgot he's the holder this year. Back out on the field.
He puts that hold down, and Bulamis drills it right through the middle. So early in the second quarter, Alabama didn't like the fact that they were behind. So they went 66 yards in 9 plays. And their quarterback for the second time this year with a rushing touchdown, 14-10. Alabama. Alabama's had some pretty good football players over the years. Nobody now has accounted for more total touchdowns than number 13.
Two of those guys are still playing. I do know that.
Yeah. I think Jalen, the last time I looked, had 4 touchdowns more today for a different team. But
it's amazing, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Alabama history, 2 of the top 3 are still playing. Hard to believe.
Bulova's kick. Fair catch signal for they'll bring it out to the 25.
Well, all,
take you back to the touchdown.
Yeah, all offseason, the message has been don't take chances with the football, Tua. This is supposed to be a sprint out, slide it to the flat. If it's not there, watch. Tua's going to check. Like he checked right there. Should I do this? No. I'm just going to run it right there. It's a lot safer. Okay, I don't want to throw across my body. I'll just take the open play. A year ago, I think he chucks that one. Now he's saying, I'm going to take care of that ball a little better.
Over there with Steve Sarkisian on the sideline. Quarterback comparison. Plumlee's played well. Hasn't had to do all that much because of a special teams turnover that led to a short score. And they got a field goal to take the lead the last time. Here he goes on the quarterback draw again. And here he goes again. Another 13-yard pickup. He is quick.
Brad, Rich Rodriguez caught a little bit of flack against Ole Miss because he ran the ball 18 out of 24 first downs. Well, in the game now, they're 10 for 10 running the ball on first down. But Ole Miss, only 11 of them went for less than 2 yards. They've been successful on first down against Alabama.
Here on first down, they lose 3 as we check in with Jamie.
Brad, Henry Ruggs doing his best to get back into this game in the tent, on the bike. He's still walking pretty gingerly, though. On the defensive side for Ole Miss, you have a questionable to return from strong safety John Haynes and a doubtful to return for that nose tackle Patrick Lucas, who is having his Achilles evaluated.
So the Landshark D down a couple of sharks. Plumlee rolling, looking to throw, and he's going to tuck it and get what he can, and got about a yard.
Gets outside, though, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does.
He can run. The first thing I did when I found that Plumlee was going to play and I saw that last series he had against Cal was go on the internet and watch him in high school. Duke can run. I'm telling you, he's fast. Committed to Georgia, decommitted on signing day, and signed with Ole Miss.
He was a Mississippi Class 6A Player of the Year. Here he is again, trying to stiff arm Trayvon Diggs. And it's going to be fourth down.
And you know how we say a lot of times that Gus Malzahn is very comfortable when he has a running quarterback. Well, Rich Rodriguez has made his career with running quarterbacks, basically.
They're thinking about going for this.
Yeah, I don't think they should. Do you?
Not in their own territory.
They might try to pull him offside, but I think this would be a bit too risky. Is he just going to bleed the clock? And try to keep, you know, run the clock down a little bit more, whether you punt from the 40 or the 38, not a big deal.
That's true. Got the crowd riled up a little bit, at least.
Burns one of his 3 timeouts.
And now they'll punt anyway. Or we assume.
You know, one of the reasons that you would burn a timeout instead of a penalty is if there was a 5-yard penalty, it could be a first down.
Alabama by 4 here early in the second quarter. Rich Rodriguez, the offensive coordinator for Ole Miss, before that last play.
I think Coach McIntyre has seen this before, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Sitting right next to him.
Didn't even phase it.
No, seen it. All of us that have played sports have been with a coach that got yelled like that. No big deal.
Mack Brown, the punter. Jalen Waddle, the return man. Side, fair catch taken at the 18, and Alabama will start to work there offensively with 12:09 to go in the half. Let's test your knowledge with today's Aflac trivia question, which is, which teams have the most wins over Alabama since the start of the 2014 season? So the last 5 years, who's beaten Alabama more? And we say teams, not teams, so there's 2 or more. There's Tua Tagovailoa with Najee Harris behind him. This a two wide receiver set, both in tight on the left because there's two tight ends out there, and Tennyson and Forrestall. Takes the handoff to Najee Harris. Time of the low. Going to Eric Long. Got a man, Devontae Smith, all the way to the 36-yard line.
Boy, how much space has a quarterback when you drop back and see that much space in front of you? You're just going, oh, please, one across and then behind again. Two players go out. The bite over the middle, you see all that space. You just love to throw those.
A 46-yard pickup, and now it's out to Judy, who's dropped right at the line of scrimmage by Jalen Julius.
Jalen Jones, number 31, one-on-one coverage. When you've got about 50 yards to cover, that is tough, not only in depth, but in width.
There's
very
a flag,
difficult.
Flag down, excuse me, Gary, flag down at a secondary back around the
eight. Legal substitution. Defense player did not get all the way off the field. Prior to the snap, 5-yard penalty. First down.
Really love the way DeAndre Smith goes up and catches the ball. He doesn't wait for it. He anticipates that the defender could be there. Go jump and take it. Beautiful.
Ole Miss couldn't get one of their players off. That's why the legal substitution was called. There's the numbers for Tua Tagovailoa today. 11 of 12, 184. He's already completed 78% of his passes coming in. He had 1,300 yards throwing, so he's closing in on 1,500 in week five. And he's got a touchdown today, which is number 18, has not thrown an interception, and he has scored on the ground today.
Well, he's got to keep pace with Hurts.
And Joe Burrow,
Joe Burrow,
a few of those guys.
Right, and Trevor Lawrence is going to get hot. You know that's going to happen here in a second.
Finished second in Heisman voting last year to Kyle Murray. And probably going to New York again this year. But there's still a lot of football to go, but he's been impressive.
We talked to him. You cannot get him off focus about the team. You can ask him any question you want, and it comes back to the team.
Yeah, he said, I don't like talking about myself. Najee Harris bounces it off the left side, and he's got a first down. So both Najee Harris and Brian Robinson running the ball better today than probably all year long.
Well, Landon Dickson, number 69, is going to come around and in the hole make the key block that time. When you're right guard, that's a counter pull by the opposite guard that time. Gets it in space, and Najee Harris has, you know, had, again, about a 6-yard run before anyone could even touch him.
Another guy down for Ole Miss at the 25-yard line.
You know, one of the things that, remember, Matt Luke was waiting for that last punt with it. I think he was also trying to accomplish is it's hot out there. He doesn't have the depth on this team. This is the first year that Ole Miss has had their full contingent of 85 scholarships, and he was just trying to keep them fresh.
Guys.
All right, Zook, thanks. Here. That was Jalen Julius, who was injured.
Yeah, I think this is him right here. He gets a block by Waddle, number 17, and then he tries to make the tackle with his left arm. And then he wants out. He kind of got like a dead arm right there, maybe a half singer. He points to the bench to get out. Couldn't get out, and they stopped the game.
Alabama first down, Ole Miss 23. Najee Harris. Strong second effort again. Finally dragged down by Kadir Shepherd.
And that's exactly what they're looking for, Najee Harris. You know, some of these guys, when they're five stars in high school, they're used to trying to make a big play. They stop, they cut, they get to the outside, they score touchdowns. They're trying to get Najee to hit the hole and be happy with 4 or 5 yards.
He's had a good game so far, as has Robinson. Most of the rushing yards for Ole Miss has been their quarterback. They have the advantage in that area. Second down and 5. Najee went one way, the fake handoff by Tua went the other way, and the pass was incomplete. Talked about Jalen Hurts having another big day for Oklahoma the last time we checked. There's the two guys compared statistics, but Jalen has played one less game, so pretty impressive couple of dudes right there.
Yep, and they remember Jalen Hurts. I know all the hell, I'm trying to remember this. Freshman of the year in the SEC, came back. saved an SEC championship game, one of the great games we've ever seen. Transfers at the right time, and Nick Saban can't say enough good stuff about Jalen Hurts.
And neither can Tua. Tua, we asked him, when's the last time he talked to Jalen? He said,
second time out of the half.
Before the first game of the regular season, we talked to each other to wish each other good luck. And I don't know if they need luck. They're putting pretty good.
Exactly.
Where our aerial coverage is sponsored by State Farm. As you're looking at Bryant-Denny Stadium, it's about 92 degrees right now, which would be one of the hottest days on September 28th ever in Tuscaloosa history. And it's almost 100 and, what would that be, 108 on the field, something like that? A warm day, let's put it that way. You don't need long sleeves, I'll tell you that much.
The fans have come in here.
Third down at 5. Alabama's only had 2 third down situations, so they're 50%. They've had such big plays, they haven't needed to run a lot of plays. This one starts at the 18-yard line. Ole Miss. Tagovailoa looks left, comes back, he's going to run. And he's going to be dragged down and almost lost the ball. Josiah Coatney brought him down.
That's another win for this Ole Miss defense. There, he got their nickel package in, take away the throws, force the quarterback to run, and Coatney comes off the block and gets a stop.
It's Ryder Anderson, the defensive end, who's down.
He's grabbing his left knee, isn't he?
Oh, man.
Yeah.
He's a nephew of a former Alabama and NFL defensive end, Mark Anderson. Ryder, junior out of Katy, Texas. They can't keep losing guys on the Landshark defense. It's 4th down and 4 for Alabama. Matt Luke's going to come out and have a look at his defensive end.
And he's lined up at tackle this time. In this rush defense, he's a speed inside rusher. Plays outside in their 3-4, but in this nickel package, he's inside. Oh. Ran into his own player,
yep,
didn't he?
Yep. Yeah.
And actually, that allowed Coatney to get up and make the play. He gets knocked down by Anderson, and that allows him to get up and make the tackle.
And the fans give him a round of applause as they help him off the field. Tyrekus Tisdale will probably take his spot on the defensive line. You see his teammate, Josiah Coatney, give him a hug.
And that just, again, takes that depth out of that defensive line, just one more after another.
You don't usually see your head coach helping you off the field. Matt, an old offensive lineman, he's big enough to help his defensive.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, it is.
I guess so. You know, Matt loves Ole Miss. His family's Ole Miss. He's Ole Miss.
Yeah. Joseph Bulovas has not attempted a field goal yet this year for Alabama. He was 14 of 18 a year ago. Will Reichard, their normal kicker, out with an injury. This is a 36-yard field goal attempt by Bulovas. On the way and good. Fans loving that because it always seems to be an adventure when an Alabama kicker knocks one home. They're up by a touchdown.
Been so far in this game, out of the 23 rushing attempts, Plumlee has 12 for 62 yards. You know, we talked about Brandon, he had to jump into the cold water. Seems like he's getting used to the water. This scene has not fazed him. He's playing against a great defense, but he has been the weapon that Rich Rodriguez has started with and stayed with for this Ole Miss offense so far. 11 first downs. Ole Miss has run the ball all 11 times.
They got a good start here after the kick out of bounds from the 35. Plumlee kind of waits and waits, and now he's going to try to get to the edge and throw it away.
This was very similar of a play that Auburn used to run with Cam Newton. It's a play action pass for the quarterback. They have a player wide open, just too quick. Be patient. He's going to come wide open down the middle of the field, and he could never in time get it. Rich Rodriguez, I know, we better not show the booth again because he's pounding that table again. He had a touchdown. He was, remember, 11 straight runs, and he pulled the trigger.
He was pulling the trigger pretty well out to the 40. To Elijah Moore.
The timing just wasn't right. Another half second and he would have had a touchdown potential play.
3rd down and 5. Alabama trying to change up their defense, and I don't think they got everybody off in time.
No.
It's going to be a first. Well, it won't be a first down. Was it third and five or third and six?
It's going to be close, that's for sure. But on third down, you know Ole Miss is going to go hurry up. And you substitute at your own risk.
Single substitution. Defense, number 94, was not off the field. 5-yard penalty will result in a first down.
And 94 is way out at the middle of the field when he realizes he's supposed to come out. And even though he's hustling as hard as he cannot get there.
And it is a first down by penalty because DJ Dale didn't get off in time. So first down at the 45. Healy hasn't touched the ball much. He's in the backfield right now with Plumlee. He's going to touch it here. And he's going to lose a yard.
Well, both Ely and Plumlee will play baseball for Ole Miss. They could be in the starting outfield for Ole Miss. It's like I get the feeling sometimes the baseball coaches go, all right, get up. It's one of my guys. I don't want him hurt.
Second and 11. Plumlee a run all the way. Well, he paid for the 2 yards he got because DJ Dale brought him down. And there's Jerrion Ely. Highly recruited by Alabama and a lot of other teams. Ole Miss pretty happy to have him.
Yeah, and the word was he wanted to play football, but had he not, he would have been a first-round draft pick as a football player.
Baseball player. Third and 9. Got to get all the way to the 45 of the Tide. Plumlee throws a little bit behind his intended receiver. It's broken up by Patrick Surtain.
Well, Jonathan Mingo, the other true freshman playing for Ole Miss, was the slant attempt. The ball was a bit high, and the defense was tight. And I think that's one that Surtain says, I defended that well. You ain't calling anything on me. I think it's a good no call.
I think that's why he was a freshman All-American last year,
yes.
And now a heck of a sophomore.
Not a good throw. You got to keep that down where just your guy can kind of go to his knees and catch that one.
Matt Brown. Carolina coach that's leading Clemson right now kicks it away and got it to Waddle, but Waddle on his way the other direction. Waddle all the way out to the 45-yard line. If you give him room, he'll do that to you. He came in averaging over 17 yards of punt return.
And I tell you, Mac Brown, that time the punter, is the guy that saves the touchdown. If he doesn't make the tackle, he's going to go.
37-yard punt and a 28-yard return. So Alabama's basically setting up shop about where the punter or the line of scrimmage was before he punted it.
He took a long time to get that punt off on that kind of rugby style. Didn't hit it well, but he did make the tackle. He did one of the three pretty well.
Brian Robinson back in behind Tua Tagovailoa. Alabama with a touchdown lead. One hand on it, and the defender got the other. Miles Hartsfield, pretty good coverage back there.
Yeah, I think Judy felt Tua was going to lead him more to the opposite sideline on this one. Judy felt that he was inside the defender, and he felt it was going to go more across the field, and he misjudged it a bit. It kind of tailed. I think Tua, when he threw that ball, it tailed to his right. So kind of like a slice in golf. He wanted to throw it more in the middle of the field, and it just kind of tailed on him.
He didn't slice many of them, but
no.
He did that one. Second down and 10. Movement man at tight end, Brian Robinson, right up the middle. Another good run.
Yeah, I'll tell you, the Leatherwood and Neal, number 70 and 73, are teaming up to take on the block and then get to the next level. And that's been the point of attack so far. The left side, the two guys are getting enough movement to begin with to make those chunk plays gain. You know, instead of making it look like an ugly 3 or 4, it's kind of a pretty 6 or 7 each time they run the ball.
Alabama looks a little confused on their personnel right now.
Yeah, because Tua was that wide receiver. They got their Slade Bolton, number 18, in at the Wildcat. Now he's got a move out. Yeah, they got her.
Timeout. I would have even called that timeout.
Hey. Brazil's first six-function multi-pro tailgate, available only on the next generation GMC Sierra. Step up to the ultimate tailgate and get over $10,000 total value on this next generation Sierra Crew Cab SLT. Or get 18% below MSRP on these Sierra SLE Crew Cab and Double Cab models with a traditional tailgate. Tailgate like a pro. GMC.
A little bit earlier, we were testing your knowledge with our Aflac trivia question.
Aflac.
Which was, which team's had the most wins against Alabama since the start of the 2014 season? Ole Miss has done it twice. Clemson in the college football playoffs has done it twice. Here at 17-10, the Tide in front with a third and three.
Yes, they do.
Throw to the outside with Judy for the first down, and Gary runs out at about the 35-yard line.
That's the problem, especially on short yardage. If you attack Tua in these short yardage plays, even if you get a free rusher, he's going to get the ball off so quick you have no chance.
Flag down on the
ineligible receiver downfield. Offense number 70. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. Repeat third down.
There's your guys downfield, Gear.
Yeah, Alex Leatherwood, that he must not have got the call at all on this play, because this wasn't an RPO, I don't think, at all. Everybody else is running pass, and Leatherwood goes down as if it's a running play. Yeah, he's confused. He thinks it's a running play. Everybody else is running. Got 10 guys running one play, one play guy running a running play.
He's chasing Sam Williams out there. It didn't need to be. So that negates the first down. It's third and eight. Tagovailoa, some pressure on him this time. Sidesteps one guy, throws on the run, and he's got Judy at the 30. First down, Tide.
Miles Hartford that time comes off the slot clean. Watch how nifty. Tua waits till the last second. I mean, on that play, he had that Aaron Rodgers kind of limp play, get around him and let it go. Those players that are coming full goal like that, you know, that is not a hard play to pass them on.
Here's a throw out to Devontae Smith.
Nice play.
And good job by Smith, Kedron Smith, to bring down Devontae Smith. We approach 6.5 minutes in the half.
Mike McIntyre, Matt Luke hires him as his defensive coordinator. They were both on the staff for David Cutcliffe here back in the early 2000s. And when Matt Luke was rebuilding his staff, he said, I'm going to go and get a guy I know. And he was the one that actually recommended Rich Rodriguez. Two Pac-12 coaches here, coordinators for the SEC Ole Miss.
Right.
Two coaches of the year.
Coaches of the year in a lot of different leagues.
Yeah.
For Rich, West Virginia, Michigan, Arizona. Second and eight. Again, a little bit of heat on Tagovailoa. Airs it out to the corner. Just missed Henry Ruggs, who's back in there.
How about that? How do you sneak in a first-round draft pick? And not only does he got a questionable leg, but you're going to make him run an out and up on the play.
Boy, he must have got some good work done on the bike over
exactly.
There on the sideline to get back in there and almost get to this ball.
And that's a tough one. You know what's hard about that is when the player restarts, he loses his momentum so much when he goes to the outside. He doesn't have that top-end speed for about 4 or 5 steps. It's easy to overthrow that pass.
Four wideouts for Bama on a third down and eight from the 25 of Ole Miss. Four-man rush, trying to the ball on a crossing route to Smith. Can he get to the sticks? You bet. He's got that. Did he stay in bounds that long?
Take the easy throw. They've been trying to tell Tua, take the easy throw and let our athletes make the plays. Coming right across the formation, little easy pitch and catch, four-man rush. Devontae Smith catches it and just out-athletes Ole Miss. A dive by Kedron Smith, number 20, but he could not make the play. How about that balance at the end of that play?
Extra point upcoming. Knocks it through with 6 minutes to go in a half. Boy, there's athletic and then there's athletic. I have no idea on a third down and eight how number six didn't go down and still stayed in bounds for yet another tied touchdown.
And that's your basic three-point turn?
If you say so.
I'm sorry?
What Pete Shearer isn't telling you is that Snapshot rewards safe drivers with discounts on car insurance.
What?
Or maybe he didn't know. I'm done with this class.
You're not even enrolled in this class.
I know, I'm supposed to be in ceramics.
Room 308.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Good luck, everybody.
Devontae Smith getting a little extra air after going 25 yards for a touchdown. Two today on a 165-yard day, and we're not to halftime. That capped the 54-yard march in six plays. Took a little over 2 minutes for Alabama to add to their lead. A couple weeks ago, Bulovas wasn't even kicking. He's going, man, my leg's getting sore. Extra points, field goals, kickoffs.
And remember what Nick told you every time he's going to kick. What is Nick going to do?
He said, I get a little nervous, and you probably do too. Holding your breath.
Exactly. He said, I'm going to hold my breath every time he goes out there.
At the four-yard line, fair catch. He'll bring it out to the 25. Thursday, CY, a comedy about getting out of the house and back in the game, is the number one new show on television. Don't miss The Unicorn, Thursday on CBS.
Well, now can Matt Luke get his team out of the half here? 6 minutes to go. They get the ball to start the second half. Can they regroup enough to keep this a ball game? You don't want to give Tua back the football back in this first half,
no,
I guarantee
really.
You.
After the play was over, illegal block pulled away. Return team number three. Half the distance to the goal. First down.
Those are the kind of penalties that are just kill you. I mean, they fair caught the kickoff and then somebody with an illegal block.
That's why you see the advanced teams, the NFL teams, the back player will wave it off. And then the other 10 guys are looking at the returner. And if he waves off, you know you're not going to have to do anything on the play.
So that puts them in a hole they didn't want to be in here with 6 minutes to go in the half.
And you got to feel Pete Golding right now, defensive coordinator for Alabama, saying, let's stop their quarterback run game first and see if they can do anything else.
Not much else on that one, maybe a yard.
Just no help at all. Anything you call is just kind of trying to figure out what you can do to help the play. Anthony Jennings, number 33, did a good job right there. I haven't called his name much.
Shaheen Carter done on the play, though. He was in on the tackle on Connor.
Yeah, I wonder if he got from behind. Anthony Jennings fell on him from behind on the tackle.
Working on the lower left leg of Shaheen Carter.
Jennings makes the tackle. Carter comes in, and Jennings falls on the back of his leg right there. Yep.
Boy, we see that so often. Friendly fire. And he is up and getting a little help to the sideline, though.
So, you know, his leg wasn't planted in the grass. Hopefully it's not too bad, but it does scare you. You feel that from behind, and you know it's a dangerous play.
Josh Jobs going to take Shaheen Carter's spot in the secondary. And for Ole Miss, they've got a second down and 9. Trailing 24-10 now after having the lead 10-7.
It's a tough call, I think, for Rich Rodriguez, offensive coordinator for Ole Miss. You know, you got a young quarterback. He's been playing well in this game. A lot of positive plays. You're backed up second and long. You're not, you know, you're going to let him throw the ball in this situation. A lot of things can go wrong. Let's see what Rich Rod dials up here.
Elijah Moore has been basically their only receiver today that's done anything. The throw is going to be deep on the other sideline, incomplete, intended for Braylon Sanders.
Yeah, and Pete Golding from Alabama kind of upped the stakes on it because he brought out the cross blitz inside with the two linebackers.
So now you're looking at 3rd and 9. This is where Alabama's defenses start salivating a little bit, 3rd and long.
Yeah, unlikely to blitz here, though. This is where they like to play their combo coverages.
Here's a little shuttle pass on the inside to Phillips. Phillips broke one tackle, not the second one. Patrick Surtain brought him down, and it's 4th down.
And good defense in time that time. We talked about the inside linebackers. That time, true freshman 35, Shane Lee, did his assignment exactly. That's where the youth is. He's got the back, plays off a block, strings it out. He knows he's going to get help and ends up making a good positive play from his linebacker spot. And he claps, he knew it.
And he forces the punt. Mack Brown is inside his own five. Again, not a good kick. Sails out of bounds. This thing might be around midfield when they finally spot it. Let's see where they're going to bring it out to. Around 45, I think, is where they'll put it down. And Alabama and Tua Tagovailoa do have another opportunity, as Gary talked about before halftime, which coming up, Adam, Rick, and BJ will have halftime analysis, scores, and highlights on the Geico Halftime Report.
Well, we have talked about everybody out here. You know, offensive line is showing well. We just showed that those inside linebackers, something that Alabama knows, has to get playing at a higher level. And quietly as can be, Tua goes 14 for 18 for 236. First half.
What'd you say to me off the air about 236 if you were playing?
Back in my day, I'd ask for a day off. I did pretty good, coach. Do I have to practice this week? Threw for 236. I mean, come on. Now it's just a whole hum day, first half.
Yeah. Of course, he's coming off a five-touchdown day last week, just about 300 yards. Completed 81% of his passes last week.
Brad, these receivers are great, but I had one just as good. Darrell Stingley was my receiver at Purdue, the NFL great player from the New England Patriots. He was just like these guys, just as athletic and as good as athletes I've ever been around.
Here's a give to Najee Harris. Cuts it up the middle. He's got a first down.
Now, we talked about the touchdown last drive. They did not use Najee Harris. They can always come back and use Najee Harris. He looked Thursday at practice as advertised. You know, when they signed him, five-star guy, you know, you're behind players. You come in the game, you get two or three carries. Struggling to find what he was. Could he find it again? Looks like he's finding himself to me.
And as a receiver as well, when he trots out to the bottom of your screen as a wideout.
Yeah, South Carolina fans will attest to him being a good receiver.
Yeah, he had two touchdowns in that one that we called in Columbia. Oh, looking right the whole way, going that way as well, and he out through Ruggs again. He was open.
Yeah. I think Ruggs is down to 4-4-5.
Yeah, that 4-2-6 isn't working.
Yeah, I don't
right
think
now.
So. Yeah, I think he's really hurt. This time it's a square in and go. Last time it was an out and go. This time it's a slant and go. Deontay Prince, going to be a good football player for Ole Miss. True freshman. He's got his hands full today covering that guy.
Tua's going, I'm throwing 4-2-6 and he's running 4-4.
Exactly.
What am I supposed to do?
But I'm not used to 4-4 guys.
Yeah.
I just say slow.
Second down and 10. Ruggs in motion behind Tagovailoa. He looks that way and comes back to a middle screen to Brian Robinson. Robinson broke a tackle. And he's going to be close to a first down. So it's Brian Robinson as a receiver this time.
When Alabama had their best teams, they had that 1-2 punch at running back. You could go one guy for a while. You know, it was Trent Richardson for a while. And then you come with Mark Ingram. Eddie Lacy would come in. You had those two guys. If Robinson comes in teams with Najee Harris, that's what they're looking for at that running back spot.
It's only his fifth reception of the year, but it's good for 9. Now back to the ground on 3rd and 1 to pick up the first down is Brian Robinson. Jaquez Jones was in on the stop on Robinson. Those two guys played high school ball together in Tuscaloosa. They just ran into each other again at Hillcrest High School.
Wow.
Not sure how many collisions they had in high school, but they had one there.
You know, Nick Saban was telling us Friday that he believed that Ole Miss was the most improved team he's seen from 18 to 19 on tape. I kind of agree with him. I mean, McIntyre's got this defense playing solid football. They're just not quite as good.
Tagovailoa, trouble. Slip through his fingers.
You know, that was directly into the sun. Could that have been? I mean, it got on him fast. I'm sure Robinson said, could you throw it a little slower? But look at the shadow, the angle of the shadow. When Robinson comes back, Tua avoids, throws a bullet, and Robinson bats it down.
Might have been a little bit behind him. He got turned around a little bit.
It would have been a tough catch. I agree with that. For a running back, you got to put him right. I think Tua is upset with himself.
I do too.
Touchdown for Robinson. At first glance, I think you were more right than I was. I thought maybe the sun, but it was behind.
Second and 10, the RPO, the pump fake by Tagovailoa, reloads and throws it behind Ruggs. Incomplete. Miles Hartsfield covering Ruggs. Brings up third down and 10 as we're just under 3 minutes in the half.
When we were visiting with Steve Sarkisian, the offensive coordinator, first year of this year back to Alabama after a stint with the Falcons, we said, do you actually think about spreading the ball around to all your weapons? He goes, yes, because, you know, you got to be like a point guard. And Tua joins in. He'll say, coach, you know, Waddle hasn't gotten the ball. Robinson hasn't gotten the ball. Let's spread it out. It's not being selfish. It's making the other team defend all of your eligible players.
See if they can pick up a third and 10 or if the Rebels can get a stop. The quick flip out to Devontae Smith. He's already got a career day, and he's got another Alabama touchdown.
You know, the receivers were talking about that they feel bad for Deontay. He doesn't get enough credit. He doesn't catch a lot of balls. But Prince gets a whiff. And then Anthony Smith, he'll always be known as second and 26 Smith to me. But you can see there may be a sliver of difference between all three of these guys in their skill level.
Bolivis for the point after. Up and good. 2:45 remaining first half. Number two, Alabama. Getting it in gear now. Capping a 45-yard drive and 7 plays is Devontae Smith again from Tua Tagovailoa. These numbers, 7, 188, and 3 for Devontae Smith. Oh, man.
I know. And the guys were feeling bad for him.
You know, I know you talked to Dan Enos in the offseason.
Yeah.
He was the Gary Danielson high school award winner back in the day.
Stop it.
Tell the story about Devontae Smith.
I said, well, who do you like better, Ruggs or Judy? And he goes, you know, I love Devontae Smith. He said he does everything. And this time, part of the everything is some blocking from his teammates. Watch Judy. Jerry Judy, who everybody says is going to be a top 4 or 5 player in the draft should he come out. Watch him block on this play. Remember they were arguing about who's the best blocker? Judy might win the argument right now.
He got two guys that time. What a day for number 6. He's got more yardage receiving than Ole Miss does total, and part of a 268-yard day for Tua Tagovailoa. And Tua, by the way, has scored on the ground as well. His Plumlee. Ole Miss has almost got to do some more passing now. They don't have a lot of choice down 3 touchdowns.
Well, Ole Miss also has to keep their head about them that we have to run and practice the offense and play the offense that we're going to play other teams against. If we try to become too much different against Alabama, we won't get ready for anybody else.
And what you really don't want to do is give Alabama the ball one more time. It's third down. Both Ely and Connor will be in the backfield flanking John Rhys Plumlee. Fakes it to Connor, and he goes deep in the middle and missed his tight end, Cooley. Xavier McKinney, number 15, guarding number 15.
Well, you're right. I don't know what you do, but you're going to get the tight end on the wheel route this time, coming straight up the field. Got man-on-man here. Actually does get by McKinney, but it would have to be a perfect pass. And McKinney, because the tight end Cooley's a little slower, is able to make up that ground. If that was their old tight end, Evan Engram.
Oh, yeah. That's a touchdown.
It's a touchdown, yes. Right about the time here. Tua's gonna look at the clock and go, oh, this may be fun.
Yep. Waddle always makes it fun. Jalen Waddle, midfield, spins, brought down by the punter again to save a touchdown. And there is a flag down at the 45. Mac Brown's going, I didn't sign up for this. Making tackles on punt returns. I'm supposed to kick the ball.
He's got two tackles. The middle linebacker's got one.
Personal foul. Tripping. Number 96. 15-yard penalty. First down.
Well, he used his foot to kick the ball. He used his foot to make the tackle. Don't see a lot of tripping calls.
Yeah. It worked. He might have gone farther. He not done it.
Here's Waddle coming right at you.
Yeah, when he gets in space with his good job by Keo, number 10, not to block the blindside block. You don't look for the knockout block anymore. Got his hands up in the air. It didn't draw the penalty.
I didn't think the first time I saw there was a trip, but he did get him with his left leg. Punted with his right. Tackled him with his left. Alabama, they haven't wasted their possessions today, I'll tell you that much. Just once, a punt. Everything else was a score. You want to end every drive with some sort of kick, be it extra point or field goal. They only failed once. Flags down. Najee Harris blasts his way down to the 17. Let's see what the flag's about. Ken Williamson, our referee. What do you got, Ken?
Illegal shift. Offense, number 4 and number 87. Did not get set prior to the snap. 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Judy and Forrest, all the tight end moving at the same time as the penalty. Next Saturday night, Mountain West Showdown over on CBS Sports Network. 16th-ranked Boise State takes on UNLV at 10:30 Eastern Time. Carter Blackburn, Aaron Taylor, Jenny Dell will bring you that one. CBS Sports Network next week. First and 15 for Alabama, now backed out to the 33-yard line. But they still got two timeouts left and a minute 36 to work.
You know, reality, the penalty was called on the two players, but it could have been on the quarterback. That's your job to make sure the line is set before you put the player in motion.
And there's Judy in motion again behind Tagovailoa. Tua looks that way to him and now goes down the middle for the home run. Devontae Smith, the fourth touchdown of the day. Holy smokes.
I know good. And number 6 is good, but watch his throw. You put a throw like this 45 yards downfield right on the button. I mean, you're sometimes when you're playing man-to-man coverage, you're depending on the quarterback to miss this throw or slow him down. You can't do it any better than that. That one didn't fade. What a throw. Taking the two may pay off.
It'll be called a 28-yard drive, but with the penalty, it's a 33-yard strike for the touchdown. Devontae Smith's got 4 of those today. Woo! Another 300-yard passing day for Tua Tagovailoa. We're not even at halftime. He's thrown 4. He's run for 1. Devontae Smith has been the main ingredient for the Tide today.
I know there's some talk that, you know, the RPO game keeps you off balance. That's true. But a guy that can throw like that with receivers that he has, put any 3 letters together, the offense will work. It doesn't matter when you can throw like that.
Fair catch again. This time, no illegal blocks on the fair catch. And to bring it out to the 25.
He was gliding into that catch. Watch him just like a ballerina. Ballet. Look at that.
That was a little Lynn Swan-ish.
It was, wasn't it? Exactly like Swanee. The body control. So if Judy's a top 5 pick and Ruggs is a top 10 pick, where would Smith go?
I don't know. Anywhere he wants.
Exactly.
Today.
Holy cow. And you know what's great? He wasn't getting a lot of balls, and he didn't say a word. He just kept working. He goes, my time will come. It's arrived.
He now has more receiving touchdowns than the other 3 guys that we've been talking about all day.
Well, you could have put music to that one.
Yeah, that was nice. Ole Miss is going to work it down inside a minute here before the next snap. They might just want to get to the locker room and regroup a little bit. They will get the second half kickoff.
Sometimes there's no strategy that can, you know, outdo talent like this.
Yeah. Time for that and a flag. And just about everybody jumped.
So, defensive coordinator Mike McIntyre for Ole
Miss. Disconcerting signals on the defense. Number 33 made an action to drew the offense off.
Okay.
5-yard penalty. First down.
So they were all drawn to jump.
Has made a point of stopping the run. But in the last three games, he's given up 300 yards passing in three straight games.
Right.
And now he's given up 300 yards in the first half. Watch number 33, Jennings. See if he slaps his hands here at the top.
There you go.
Well, I don't know why that would make all these guys way over here move and not the guys right next to the clap.
He must have the loudest clap of all time.
Yeah, but it passes by people and goes to other people.
Reverberates down the line. Here's Plumlee trying to get to the edge. Got a holding.
Ontario Drummond, number 11, right at the end of the play.
I think it was Phil Mathis that he bulldogged down.
Yep.
Personal foul. He led the block on the waist. Offense number 7. 15-yard penalty from spot of the foul. Repeat first down.
Jason Pellerin right there, right to the right side of your screen.
No, it was Lee that he got.
Yeah, it was Lee. I thought that's a new rule now. You can only block below the waist when you come directly at a player. You can't come from his blind spot and block below the waist.
That's a good rule.
I think that's a rule, but maybe Gene's done having a beer and he could help us on that one. He earned it, though. I'm telling you that right now.
If you're just joining us, Gene's not drinking beer. Gary just offered to buy him one for the call.
He was that was so good, I'm
yeah.
telling you.
Yeah. And Alabama isn't going to stop this, even though they got a couple of timeouts. Is they're going to be comfortable with a 4-touchdown lead going to the locker room? This is going to be the final snap if it snaps. And it is. Plumlee's going to air one out. Why not? On the sideline. Incomplete. Sertan maybe could have been called for an interference, but no flag. Well, Ole Miss had a lead in this half. If you just joined us when it was 10-7, Devontae Smith sort of took that lead away. It's 38-10. End of the first half. Jamie's halftime interview with Coach Saban. Go to Twitter at SEC on CBS. But right now, Adam Zucker and the guys in our New York studio. Fellas.
All right, Ness, thank you very much. Gonna hit retweet.
Halftime at Tuscaloosa, Alabama, with a 38-10 lead over the Rebels of Ole Miss. Each week, we'll be celebrating college football's 150th anniversary with A Taste of Tradition presented by Sonic. Here's Jamie.
Brad, in 1969, college football was celebrating its 100th anniversary, and Ole Miss and Alabama gave the sport a game for the ages. They met under the lights at Birmingham's Legion Field in the first nationally televised primetime game in SEC history. Rebel quarterback Archie Manning was spectacular, accumulating 540 yards of offense and 5 total touchdowns. But Alabama's quarterback Scott Hunter was equal to the task, throwing for 300 yards of his own and the winning touchdown late in the fourth quarter. 50 years later and counting, that game is etched in SEC and college football lore.
Watch that. And Crimson Tide of Alabama actually trailed in this game as they head back out onto the field at Bryant-Denny Stadium. They lead 38-10. Welcome back, everybody. Brad Nessler, Gary Danielson, Jamie Erlaus down on the field. End of the first quarter, partner. I said, hey, we got a football game. Ole Miss was in the lead at the time. Things kind of fell apart a little bit.
Yeah, 223 yards later, yep. For 31 straight points by Alabama. You know, you have 3 NFL receivers, an NFL quarterback, an NFL right tackle. Yeah, I mean, they got a lot of talent there. And once they get that ball flying around, it's like a feeding frenzy.
It's been a virtuoso performance, yes. Again by Tua Tagovailoa and especially Devontae Smith. There he is, who's about one catch away. It's anything over 3 yards for the single game, receiving record of Amari Cooper. He's already got four touchdown catches today, and that is a single-game school record. And Tua Tagovailoa, I don't know how much longer he will play, but he's got four touchdown passes and one on the ground today, so another five-touchdown day through two quarters for him.
Well, I think he goes at least a series. You know, if he scores, he might come out, but you're going to go at least a series, I would say, with him. No, it's worse to take him out and have to put him back in than just let him run another series.
Fair catch again taken by Ealy. So Ole Miss will start from the 25 as we check in with Jamie.
Frustration level topping out for Ole Miss. When I spoke with head coach Matt Luke, those mental errors that led to a lot of those penalties, he said this is a team that we don't need to help at all. As far as that true freshman, John Rhys Plumlee, who's getting his first start at quarterback, he said he's doing just fine with his feet. We need to help him out on the outside, and when he does decide to take that offense on his own, we got to protect him.
That they do. And he'll go to work with his team at the 25.
You know, I think Coach Luke is right to point out the mistakes they're making, because for the rest of the year, that's what you have to concentrate on, being a better football team.
Plumlee fakes the pass and then takes off on his own. Got about eight before he's run out of bounds. As you take a look at the first half game trends, Tua's got a school record now of 84 career touchdowns accounted for. Four touchdowns is a school record, and as I said, Devontae's about a catch away from the most yards ever. And there's what the freshman that Jamie just spoke of has done, including a seven-yard gain on that last carry. Empty backfield. He's going to throw a quick slant, and his receiver just stopped. I don't know if there was some confusion between the two, but it was intended for Elijah Moore.
And Moore was targeted so much by Matt Corral that before Plumlee came in again, he's used to a lot of targets. But now with the running quarterback, it's different.
He's going to try to get the first down, and does, on a third down and three. Had five wideouts, and he did it himself out of an empty backfield.
This has been the offense. It has been the quarterback run game. That's basically it. They've had a couple of off-balance runs or passes in the game. Might have had a big play on the quarterback, type of a flea flicker play, but it didn't time out right. But otherwise, it's been all quarterback run.
This time he fakes the pitch and goes to the left and goes out as he got about six more. Xavier McKinney there for Alabama to make sure he didn't get more than six. It's a way to start the quarter, though. Just keep moving the sticks if you can. Play action, the throw, the outside shoulder. Nice. Did he get it? And Nick Saban saying he was bobbling it, but the linesman said no. It's a catch. Gary talked about this earlier, the dual threat quarterbacks Rich Rodriguez has had. Pat White at West Virginia. Bernard Robinson of Michigan. And whoops, this dual threat just got threatened by Terrell Lewis.
Yeah, if you watch this, Terrell Lewis looks like he checks to see if the running back has the ball. And when he does it, he said, well, then the quarterback must have it. It's as if he says, all right, I got the running back. And then he says, no, running back doesn't have it, so I'm going to take the quarterback. What a play. Hard to show replays. Louise coaching Michael fast, no matter what.
Second and 16. Plumlee has plenty of time and are running out of it. Raquan Davis giving chase. And he throws behind his intended receiver, Dontario Drummond. Didn't quite finish with Khalil Tate at Arizona of the dual threat quarterbacks under Rich Rod. Pretty exciting players, those three. Today it's a heavy toll for a freshman against the number two team in the country.
It's pretty tough to come in here without your main quarterback. I mean, there's no doubt about Matt Corral was starting to get his feel, and he would bring more passing to the to this Ole Miss team, and they need it. Just a running quarterback is not enough. He's a good runner, but you got to be able to throw.
And he's going to run again on third down and 16. Hurdles one guy.
Beautiful.
Wow.
He's an athlete, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, he went over Shaheen Carter.
Just remember, I mean, he's quarterback for Ole Miss, had committed to Georgia.
Right.
And recruited as an athlete, recruited by Alabama as an athlete. Pete Golding said we'd like him as a projected safety in the future, but you can see the type of athlete he is.
Still came up short on that run, so it's fourth down, and they'll have to kick it away. Mack Brown to punt. Take those two or three steps to the right.
That was a good one. A little too deep this time.
And this time he got too much on it into the end zone. It'll be a touchback, and Alabama will go back to work from their own 20. Early third quarter, Alabama on offense when we come back. Now it's all Alabama 38-10. Behind Tua Tagovailoa and Najee Harris. Tua throws quickly to Jerry Jeudy. Jeudy, little half step. Whoa, he got away and almost took off. Kedron Smith knocked him out, but Hartsfield, I think, was the guy that he left in the dust.
You know how when we do college games, we always go, you know, Jerry Jeudy reminds me of this guy. I think we should do it the other way. What NFL guy reminds me of Jerry Jeudy? He's special, I tell you.
Najee Harris, good run. Picked up about six. So both Najee Harris and Brian Robinson.
I know it's hot out there, and I know the fans, you know, it's somewhat of a blowout here with the score. But, you know, I got to give a lot of credit to the fans. They're out, especially the ones in the sun on the far side, sitting out the rest of this game and staying there. They don't want Nick Saban mad at them leaving early. He notices that.
Yes, he does.
But it's a hot day out there, and they're sticking through so far.
That's the first thing sometimes Nick mentions at his news conference. The folks that stay, he appreciates the hard work they put in hot temperatures.
You want to have the seats on the shade side.
Yeah, absolutely. We're in the shade, by the way, yes, if you're wondering.
Yeah, we'd be on this side, the nice, cool side. Talking to the changes, we're going to move our booth down, I heard, a little bit next year.
That'd be nice.
Yeah, a little more run. It's terrible here. We're on the 25-yard line. It's hard to live here to do this game. I feel sorry for us. A lot of people are probably feeling sorry for us.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. People have paid to sit on the 25-yard line. We would never do that. No. We don't have that kind of money.
People might.
At the 46. Najee Harris off the left side. Najee's got another first down. Big man puts out a big move at the end to pick up extra yardage. And the last couple weeks, he's been starting to get going.
All right, Devontae Smith is looking for the record for receiving yardages, but you know what he's doing until he waits for that? The left side of your screen, he's going to be the guy blocking downfield right there. Watch him stick and do his job outside. It's going to be a tough argument. Judy's got a good block. We're going to show you a little later. Ruggs has a good block, and now Smith has had a good block.
Smith in motion at the snap. Najee Harris trying to go that same way.
Yep.
And good job defensively by Jacquez Jones. Checking him, Jamie.
Well, despite the call for action recently, so we're going to hear which penalty this is before I tell you this riveting story.
Sorry, I threw it to you, Jamie.
No worries.
I didn't see the flag.
No worries.
With you.
Personal foul, hands to the face, defense number 97. 15-yard penalty, previous spot, automatic first down.
Kadir Shepherd. And we'll get back to Jamie after we see the hands to the face by Shepherd. Matt Luke's like,
yeah, it was
tough enough, guys.
Number 87 for Alabama was on the block. And did we show it? I didn't see it. Punishment. Right at the end up there. There's the call. Job by our truck guys getting that thing before the snap.
Tiger below. Smith.
Goodness.
Number five and a new single game yardage record, a 28-yard score.
Not bad coverage this time. Miles Hartsfield is right there, pushes Smith wide, balls up. Smith goes up and get it at the highest possible point. Hartsfield keeps fighting the whole way. Smith gets bumped by Najee Harris that time, his good buddy, but I'll take that for a touchdown pass, wouldn't you? Yep. Might be the last time we see either one of those guys in this football game, right?
Yep. What a... It's not a two-man show, but just with the stats, it sure is.
You mentioned Lynn Swann before, but that's Lynn Swann right there for sure.
Bolivis' extra point is good. You know, if you just want to watch poetry in motion, just stick around. We're not quite sure what else could happen. But Devontae Smith has been nothing short of miraculous, and so is his quarterback. Hooking up fifth time. An 80-yard Alabama drive in about a minute and a half and three plays, and that guy on the end of it again. I don't know. Sometimes it's just fun to watch, Gary, you know?
Yes, and when you can do that, and, you know, that's not a big window. That's good defense. But when you can fly, keep your feet in bounds, put those type of yards out, I mean, you know, there's a lot of names around here. Julio Jones, Amari Cooper, Calvin Ridley, and then these three guys.
All right, now we'll go back to Jamie.
Well, the hands to the face took over my fans to the face that I was going to talk about for those people sitting in the sun. But they are going to get rewarded for the fact that they are going to stay close to the fourth quarter as we inch get there. The app is called Tide Loyalty Points, and students receive points based on their attendance at these games. Now, they have to stay through the start of the fourth quarter. Their phone is able to tell that they were still in the stadium. The athletic director at Alabama said, we don't want to penalize these students. We want to incentivize. So when they get points, they inch their way closer to receiving tickets or line in the tickets for SEC championship, national championship. They might want points per yardage that Devontae Smith gets today. I would argue for that.
Gary's wondering if he has that app on his phone right now.
They know you're still here, Gary.
It's not fair. Should have said that about Brad, Jamie.
Jared Ely is a guy they haven't gotten involved today very much. And he's had some big games early in the season.
Jamie is a smart girl. She's in the shade. I can see that.
Again, trying to throw a slant.
Oh, it was Diggs that time, was it? Trayvon Diggs. I have seen projections for the Alabama players that they could have as many as 7 first-round draft picks. The all-time record is 6 in the first down. There is a projection if everyone comes out, the young players, that they could have 7. And after if they keep throwing the ball to Devontae Smith, they could have 8.
I'd take any of them, I think, right now. Here comes a delayed blitz by Sean Lee. Get a chase out Plumlee. Plumlee got around him. And he's all the way to the 40.
I mean, that's a 5-star linebacker, Shane Lee, that was chasing him and cannot get there in time. Free rusher from a dead stop. He outruns Lee to the corner. That is some serious wheels.
96 yards and a touchdown, but there has been little help. Now he's going to go deep, try to get a big one, and he did.
Beautiful.
Jonathan Mingo. Freshman to freshman on that one.
Well, that's the hope for the growth of the Ole Miss program right there. The true freshman quarterback who can run like that when he gets the passing game down. There's another true player who played through 3 or 4 more years. That's the future what Ole Miss is looking at.
That's the play fake, trying to go right back to him after the 32-yard pickup in front of Patrick Surtain. And he's going to be called for pass interference, it appears, on the same receiver, Jonathan Mingo.
Yeah, I think he grabbed him, didn't he, when he turned around? This is a stop route. Yeah, he grabbed him from behind. That's a good call.
He did everything but throw him down.
Automatic first down.
And an automatic first down, so Ole Miss has got something working here.
Well, if you want to win in this league with modern rules and athletes, you have to bring the passing game. There's too many yards out there. There's 250 to 300 yards passing every game. Now, I'll take the quarterback runs in addition, but you got to bring me some passes as well.
He puts his head down and goes down.
He is quick, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. He had a game earlier this year where he had a freshman Ole Miss all-purpose yardage record, 273 yards with kick returns and rushing and all that, and broke Dexter McCluster's freshman record, and he was a heck of a player for Ole Miss. They'd like to have him become that kind of player.
Now, this is going to be interesting right now because Ole Miss substituted and Alabama substituted late. So they got time to make the late substitution. Good job by the officials.
Second and 6, here is Ely. Inside the 10. Justin Eboigbe Freshman defensive lineman made
the
stop.
Look what's going to be set up, though, on the play. The outside play after the handoff here. Watch the lead for the quarterback. Two guys outside for the sweep to the outside. That's the setup off the inside run play.
They're down at three. Two wideouts, Jackson and Sanders, a full backfield. Alabama brings some pressure. Plumlee comes up throwing. Got it to Ely. A stutter stop and a touchdown.
Beautiful. Athletic skill.
So they finally did get it to number nine and some space, and he shows you what he can do.
Absolutely. A lot of young, good talent on this football team. Match up against some young, good, old, good, every talent, every great talent. But this time he shows the stop and the go. Overrun by the inside linebacker. Remember, that's one of those positions that Alabama has to find out more about. With the loss of, you know, Dylan Moses, their All-American inside linebacker, that's one of the positions that has been worrisome for Alabama's defense.
Luke Logan threw the point after. Up and good. So good-looking drive. They desperately needed one, and they got it.
You know what that means, though? We're going to see more two.
You think so?
Yes, we are. I guarantee you.
First career touchdown pass. Good job, John Rice. Capped a 75-yard march in seven plays with that toss to Ely for the touchdown. It'll be nice and cool there, too,
it
next
is.
Saturday.
I was thinking about...
Here's another pooch kick. No fair catch taken. On the fly by Diggs. Reversing his field. Trayvon Diggs got to the edge. He's in Ole Miss territory.
He steps out and just goes, okay. Trayvon Diggs started his career as a wide receiver and ended his career as a defensive back. And guess who got another block? Number six, the guy who's got all the records in the game. He's out there on kickoff team and gets a big block on the play.
So the starting
right in front, he's following number six. There he is.
Starting defensive back gets a two blocks from starting wide receiver.
Isn't that great?
Yeah. All the way to the 39-yard line of Ole Miss. The fourth time Tua has had five touchdown passes in a single game, including today. And they all went to Devontae Smith. Here's Brian Robinson dancing around to get a couple. Robinson and Najee Harris close to combining for 100 yards on the ground now for Alabama.
Devontae Brown is in the game right now, right? Number 65, coming off his suspension. He's not in playing shape yet. He's going to earn his spot back. I think he's playing right guard right now. I believe it's hard to see if it's 65 or not. It is 65.
Play action. Tagovailoa throws, crossing route to the tight end, and he's out of bounds around the 15. Miller four-star.
And offensive line did a good job of giving 13 time to look downfield, and I think this is one of the plays where Tua said, you know who hasn't got the ball all day?
My tight end.
Yeah, he's been blocking all day. Let's feed a little candy to our tight end right here. Give it to him.
Got it to the 16. Forrestall stays in there with Randolph, the other tight end. Robinson looking for a place to hide. Got a yard. There's Big Deontay.
He is a very physical football player. There were a lot of people thought that his injury or suspension last year really hurt their football team at the end of the year.
He's a road grader, that's for sure.
Is.
Second and nine at the Ole Miss 15. Jerry Jeudy in motion. Again, Mr. Robinson. And Robinson blasts his way for about three more. As the clock works its way down to 6.5 to go in the third quarter.
Josiah Cody, number 40, did a good time that time getting penetration and blowing up that play before it really got started.
Third down and five. And Alabama taking their time here, using a little bit of clock. Robinson comes out. Najee Harris comes back in. That's what we were talking about between the two guys today.
You know, it's getting to the point, though, as good as these receivers are, and Tua is, your running game on this team is just going to be the second part of the offense. It cannot be the lead part of the offense. They're too good throwing the ball.
Judy on the move. Tagovailoa throws again to the tight end, and that one's broken up.
I don't think it was a very accurate pass. I don't think Tua was very happy with himself on that one. He was trying to feed the ball again to his tight end, had the slant route. I thought he should have completed that one.
Well, it gives Bulovas a chance to kick some more. This will be a 29-yard attempt. Again, he was the starting kicker a year ago. Will Reichard, the freshman, has a hip flexor problem, and that's why he's not kicking today. But Bulovas has been perfect so far with field goals and extra points. Until now. I didn't set him up. It just happened.
Just the history of the kicker. It's tough.
Juju, what are you guys doing?
How about graduate in December?
Well, he probably came into school for the spring semester while he was in high school, right? So he got an extra spring practice. Some of these kids nowadays are testing out of classes in high school, so he probably did some of that. Probably cost, you know, like $12 to go to college.
Still smart dude.
Yeah, 4.0 is the...
Yes, that's about as best you can do. Plumlee.
Watch out, safety right there. McKinney had a good throw there.
Going into the secondary. Speaking of the secondary, you pointed this out. The grad assistants on this team for Alabama would be a pretty good defensive secondary right now.
We've seen them all play.
Yeah, we have.
We've been doing these games, and they are...
There they are.
That's a pretty good secondary right there.
Now with that, Javier Arenas could shag punts, too.
Exactly.
So get a lot of stuff done with the grad assistants. Plumlee throwing on the run. A little bit high for Dontario Drummond.
I was pointing out to Coach Saban yesterday in our meeting that if you look at the NFL stats, Bill Belichick's ex-coaches that are head coaches now, his coaching tree and Bill play more man coverage than any other NFL team. And it seems like if you watch this Alabama game, they're almost got to be 75% man-to-man coverage in the game.
Here comes extra pressure on Plumlee. He's going to go deep again and still overshot Elijah Moore.
I've always said that if you're going to beat Alabama, you better be ready to beat their bump and run corners out to the outside. You know, when Texas A&M beat them, Mike Evans and Johnny Manziel did it right here in this stadium. Trevor Lawrence did it with throwing to the outside against bump and run. Deshaun Watson did it. You must be able to attack their one-on-one coverage. If you just concede that they're covered, you can't beat this defense.
Matt Brown has it blocked. In the air. On the ground. Touchdown, Alabama.
That's who blocked it.
Alay Kaho blocked it, and he scored it.
Well, we thought it was close earlier, right, that he almost got one blocked. And that slow rugby ended up biting him. A block, a drop, and a recovery. Jeez, that's like rubbing salt into the wound, isn't it?
Yeah. And that's a happy backup linebacker right there. Sophomore out of Reno, Nevada has just tacked on six more. The seventh point is good. And Alabama's got 52 on the board. 5:29 remaining third quarter. Special teams with a special play for the Tide. And they extend their lead here in Tuscaloosa. Real coverage here in Tuscaloosa, sponsored by State Farm. As you look in at Bryant Denny Stadium and Joseph Bulovas, who's got it teed up to kick away. And again, fair catch taken by Ely, was chosen not to return any today. Let's get an update for you. Adam Zucker in New York. Zuck.
Hey, Ness, you know, Clemson has not been clicking, but they are back on top. Trevor Lawrence on third and long with his first touchdown pass of the day. T. Higgins there, and with under 10 minutes to go, Clemson on top, 21-14 in Chapel Hill. Back to you.
Well, the Tar Heels giving them all they can handle.
Yep.
Ole Miss gave Alabama what they could handle for 15 minutes today and actually had the lead in this game. But now it's a tied 52-17. Ole Miss scored on their last drive, went 75 yards with Plumlee leading the way with both his legs and his arm. See what he can do this time. They'll keep it on the ground. Nice opening for Scotty Phillips, his biggest run of the day. Goes for about 20.
Well, they ran at Nick Broeker, 64, the true freshman left tackle. Alex Givens, number 67, comes around and pulls around. Givens, who struggled with back surgery, really didn't attend fall camp. No, big right tackle for Ole Miss and just playing his way into shape.
First down to the 45, a blitz off the corner. Plumlee got rid of it and overshot Miles Battle. And the Power Five the last 3 years, Clemson, Alabama, Ohio State, Oklahoma, Georgia. Everybody says, what if the last four are Alabama against Oklahoma and Ohio State against Georgia? Jalen Hurts against Tua Tagovailoa and Justin Fields against Jake Fromm.
Yeah, and don't forget Joe Burrow could play one of those teams.
That's right.
Transfer Ohio State for LSU. Ohio State could be a nice matchup, but those are the teams, right? Those are the, I think there's six teams that have separated themselves.
Last three meetings, combined score. We mentioned last year, Ole Miss scored the first play, and then 62 points later, it was Alabama 62-7. Today, Ole Miss had a 10-7 lead, and 52 on the board now for this Alabama team. Here comes a blitz. Look out. Plumlee. And again, he might have gotten a first down. He has got some zip to him.
Yeah, that time, though, you're right. I agree with that. But Brian Young doesn't have a chance. He's a defensive lineman is not going to get there. He runs actually pretty well for a defensive lineman, but not like Plumlee. But, again, it was that five-man rush and got outside the rush. That's what really broke down the play for the Alabama defense.
And you saw that doesn't happen very often to a Nick Saban coach team, having a quarterback run for more than 100 yards, which Plumlee has done today.
He's accounted himself very well. He has a very bright future. He's got to work on his passing game. I'm sure he will. But I think he may be right. A lot of people recruiting him as a safety or wide receiver. He wanted to play quarterback. He's showing it. He's got a lot of skills. And fits this Rich Rod offense pretty well, don't you think?
Yes. I don't know if he wanted to run that play, but he lost a little bit of yardage. We talked about some of what he does in the off time from away from football. Got a little Billy Joel going there.
Yep. I got a feeling he might not have a lot of problems getting dates. Do you?
I can play football and I can serenade you.
Yeah, play baseball too. Yeah. You know, anything you like, I got that sport.
Here he goes on a quarterback draw. Jennings tracks him down along with Raekwon Davis to make the stop.
They will obviously go for it. Fourth and short. Got a player down.
That's Jalen Cunningham getting up slowly. Left guard. Looks like he's staying in. Can't imagine what the Big Eaters are feeling like right now.
Can you imagine how tired they are?
Yeah. Fourth and two.
Xavier McKinney is telling everybody what to do over there. He is the quarterback out in the field. Without Dylan Moses out there, it falls on number 15.
Forced a timeout with fourth and two upcoming.
At Chipotle every night.
Later in the game, the play of the game presented by Jersey Mike Subs. I have a feeling it won't be Jalen Waddle's muffed punt, but I think it might be something to do with that guy. We'll wait and see. So fourth down. John Rice, Plumlee in the shotgun.
No safety at all in the middle of the field. You got to believe they're coming after if you're the quarterback. Here they come.
Plumlee lofts it. Just missed Elijah Moore. Had him turned around, and Moore just couldn't track that thing.
Again, the challenge here against a young quarterback pretty well, but look at the easy read. The quarterback knows it's an all-out blitz, one-on-one coverage, not a really great throw on the play. And, you know, you wonder when they start facing, you know, Fromm and Lawrence and Burrow and those type of guys, you know, that's when this defense is really going to be tested.
Well, their quarterback has another five touchdown day, but he is still in there. Tua Najee Harris in the Alabama backfield.
We should talk about that a little bit. I wonder if he's going to get a curtain call here or is
Najee Harris.
Sometimes I feel one of the things that Nick Saban might have learned from maybe the lesson from last year is everything was so easy that his offense didn't play a lot of time in the second half. I wonder if he's saying, you know what, whatever the score is, we need to play and we need reps.
We need to get to a fourth quarter and
exactly.
Still have to be out there.
Yeah, because at the end of the year, it looked like they had not even been in a close game and weren't ready for the Georgias and the Clemsons.
Najee Harris got seven, second down and three. And that one batted down by the Ole Miss defense. And DeAndre Prince knocked it away. We've got another update in New York. Here's Adam.
All right, Nash, we're going to the swamp. The Gators against Auburn next week on CBS. Getting a look at their backup quarterback, Emory Jones. Zipping one to Keon Zipperer after his own 29-yard run. 38-0 on the Towson Tigers. Different stripes next week.
That's right. So let me give Auburn's defensive coordinator something else to think about for next week.
That'll be an interesting game where, you know, the second half of this SEC schedule, all these teams meeting each other is going to be something.
Yeah, a bunch of undefeateds right now, but somebody's going to have to go.
Uh-oh.
Crossing route. Najee Harris broke the tackle. Didn't quite get to the first down marker, though. Nice job by Ole Miss defense to bring him down short of the sticks. Next Saturday, we talked about it. First meeting in 8 years. And a top 10 matchup, number 7 and number 9. From the swamp. Hope you join us. So fourth down. Good job by Ole Miss. Their defense to hang in there. Skyler DeLong is only his what, second punt? Yeah, they have one in the first half. Hangs one up high. They'll just clear out of the way and let it roll down at about the 17-yard line. There with a minute 23 remaining. Ole Miss, Sellers Shy, what is it, the fourth, something like that? Sellers out of Memphis University High School came out as the scout team player of the week last year, got to bring the flag out, and he is the son of one of our friends and cohorts, co-workers. Sellers Shy, here he is as the scout team quarterback this week, getting ready for Alabama.
Well,
you talked to his dad.
I talked to him on the phone. You worked with him a whole year as your producer, right?
Yep.
Year. We all love Sellers. I called him this week. He picks up the phone. Hi, G. I said, how's it going? Well, big play here. Hold off. Busted one. Talked about the phone. How's it going? He goes, great. I'm in Shanghai, China. I go, wait a second. We're both on cell phones, and you're in Shanghai, China. Yes, covering a golf tournament. Of course, Sellers works with Steve Milton, director, and now all our golf coverage all year. And Sellers, quite a golfer, and very proud of his son being a quarterback here for Ole Miss.
Long list of Sellers Shy, who were at Ole Miss. Let's get another update. Adam's got something for us.
Oh, yeah, Ness. Notre Dame using sacks to set up touchdowns. Julian Okwara with the strip sack on Virginia's Bryce Perkins. Ade Ogundeji going in for the score. By the way, Tua's cousin Myron had a long run back to set up another score.
Well, the Tua families. And here goes another great run by, that's a face mask, too, you would think. Jared Connor, Snoop Connor, they call him. He's had some big runs in this late stages of the quarter.
This staff worked very hard on this whole recruiting group. And Snoop is another one of those true freshmen. They're starting to rebuild the program. And it's tough to grow in the SEC. You're either grown or you're in trouble.
Well, when you're coming off scholarship limits,
exactly.
Too, and they're finally back to where they can get a full complement of players. That'd be the final play of the quarter here. Plumlee, a run all the way. Didn't get back to the line of scrimmage, but he did get to the end of the quarter. We played three in Tuscaloosa. End of the third quarter score, Alabama 52, Ole Miss 17. We'll return to Tuscaloosa right after this message and a word from your local station. Two-yard line. Plumlee moves Snoop Connor over to his left shoulder. Drops to throw. Let's see if he takes off or throws. He will pull up and go across the middle. Nice toss and catch. And a first down to the 29-yard line. So we welcome you back to the booth at Bryant-Denny Stadium. 15 minutes from now, Alabama's going to be 5-0, and they'll go into their bye week with a 5-0
run. And a good time. I think, you know, they played a little bit talent they can't play with them. Now they got to get ready for the second half of the season. They've got three big games coming up that they have to be ready for and healthy for. And I'll say this, when you're going to play Alabama, you better bring your offense. They're going to put points on the board, so you got to score as well. Your only chance of staying with them is a score.
And while Ole Miss has scored 17 today, hasn't been nearly enough even after they had a 10-7 lead. Here's what we're looking at schedule-wise. A&M at College Station, and then Tennessee and Arkansas here. Then another open date, and then the big clash on November 9th right here in Tuscaloosa against, right now at least, unbeaten LSU. And an LSU team that is totally different than what we're used to.
Yep.
Connor brought down by Anthony Jennings after a one-yard gain.
Jennings has been very active in this football game today. He, you know, he's one of those guys that you don't talk a lot about. Stays healthy, coming off the edge, rushes the passer. A lot of experience now handling, you know, what basically is modern football. The zone read, running backs, quarterbacks keeping the ball. He's seen it all.
Play fake. Plumlee's just got to throw this one to the sideline. Xavier McKinney and Jared Maiden were putting the heat on him.
They got their, I guess it is their dime defense in the game right now. Six defensive backs, one linebacker, and that's why you can see these blitzes. It's called a, what you call a key blitz. Both of those players right there are covering the running back. They both rush at the running back. Wherever the running back takes, the other guy takes the quarterback.
Oh,
you have to be disciplined, but it is effective.
Has no choice but to go on fourth down. Lofted one out there. Perfect throw and catch. Touchdown, Mingo.
Mingo's been impressive, hasn't he?
Yeah, he has. Freshman to freshman again.
See a flag. It must have been a late hit on the end of the play on Plumlee as well. Mingo has handled those 50-50 balls really well. I think it was Xavier McKinney that came in late on the court.
Let's go, boy.
And they're all the way over the sideline. Meanwhile, we get a look.
Personal foul. Welcome to passer. Defense number 99. Touchdown's good. 15-yard penalty will be enforced on a succeeding kickoff.
Yeah, Xavier McKinney was matched up that time on Mingo. That's a tough matchup for the safety and delivered very well. It's a 50-50 ball to the outside. You're blitzing, and now you've got one-on-one. Back shoulder throw, and, you know, DK Metcalf, A.J. Brown. We've seen a lot of guys, big size Ole Miss receivers in the past.
Yeah.
Plays just like that.
Extra point is good. So Ole Miss not going away with 13:23 remaining. Still playing hard on the road against the second-ranked team in the country. And Mingo caps a freshman-to-freshman connection to cap an 83-yard drive in 3 minutes. And the touchdown for the Rebels. For our ExxonMobil game recap here in Tuscaloosa, Ole Miss got off to a nice start on the road and actually put Alabama behind for the first time this year. Plumlee took it in on the one-yard touchdown. Alabama came back. Tua Tagovailoa is going to keep it himself here on a seven-yard touchdown run. Ole Miss went up on a field goal to lead 10-7, and then the record started to fall. Tagovailoa crossing route, Devontae Smith. Great balance to get to the end zone. And no, that was not the first time he's going to the end zone. He's going for an SEC tying record, five trips to the end zone. Off the arm of Tua Tagovailoa. A sensational day. It's 372 passing yards, almost 500 total.
You know, he is deceptive, too. He gets on that corner fast. It does not look like he's running full speed. It looks like he's gliding, and he gets on those DBs quick.
And he's out there on the kick return team right now. His numbers, 9 catches, 248 yards, and 5 touchdowns off the left arm of his quarterback.
Well, that's kind of interesting. They go for a few pooches and onside kicks, and then after the penalty, they kick it out of the end zone. I would have tried an onside right there.
Let's check in with Jamie.
Well, Brad, we got some insight into how fun it must be to be a wide receiver on this Alabama team. Last week, video emerged of Devontae Smith and Jerry Jeudy playing rock, paper, scissors in the middle of their game to decide which one was going to run a route that they knew was going to go for a touchdown. Nick Saban this week said there's a fine line between players having fun together and making it about themselves. He feels like they were just having fun. Here's the thing, though. Jeudy won that game. I feel like Devontae Smith practiced this week a little bit because he has gotten all the routes this today.
And Waddle's going to have to work on that thing because he doesn't have a touchdown catch yet
this year.
He's
going with scissors too much. You got
here comes Devontae again. And he's got about 15 more yards and a flag down at the end of the play.
I wonder if this is going to be a peelback block on Jerry Jeudy. And it could be targeting as well.
You mean
be
either.
Careful.
There is no foul for
a
blindside block. The block was from the front. Second, first down.
So that would be rock, not paper or scissors. Not right there. That was rock. Here's another look.
It's kind of come in to the left side, hits it, and it was close. I know the flag was called in the new block. You cannot take a blind shot block at a guy that cannot see the block coming.
Slade Bolden in the lineup. And now Brian Robinson joins Tua in the backfield. They fake it to him, and Tagovailoa going for Smith. No, it's not Smith. It's John Metchie. I was thinking number 6 because I've seen so much of it today, but it's number 8.
John Metchie has earned some playing time for Alabama, a true freshman receiver that Coach Tolis has earned a couple shots. He's going to be a great player and got some guys in front of him, but that's number 8, a guy you're going to be watching in the next few years.
Freshman out of Ontario, Canada. Jeudy and Smith will both be out to Tagovailoa's right side. And now he'll move Jeudy back the other way. Second and 10. Brian Robinson broke a tackle. Robinson, another good run across midfield.
Well, we talked about it before. Brian Robinson started out so hot in this game, making people miss and getting those pods of yardage. Najee Harris is the lead back. But as we talked about, Alabama, when they had it going well, always had two of them. Mark Ingram, Trent Richardson, Eddie Lacy, T.J. Yeldon, Kenyon Drake, Damian Harris. Josh Jacobs, last number one draft pick, and just had a bunch of them.
A lot of them still playing on Sunday.
Whoa.
Throw out to Jeudy. Looking for a block from his tight end, but nice job with the open field tackle to bring him down by A.J. Finley. As we get another update in New York, here's Adam.
All right, Brad, moments ago, North Carolina scored to get within 1 with a minute to go on Clemson, but they want 2 in the lead, but the Tigers sniffed it out. Sam Howell tries to share it, not happening. Clemson got the onside kick, just took the final knee. 21-20, the escape.
Oof, escape it is.
I will say this, though. Probably going to put Alabama as the number one team in the country in the next poll.
It to Smith, and Smith's to the 40. And that'll be his 11th catch of the day.
And I think there's a message here. I mean, it is true that Ole Miss has come back and scored to put 24 points. And I think Nick Saban wants his team playing into the fourth quarter. Battle test them a little bit more than last year.
4 minutes into that quarter right now as Robinson carries
nothing,
again.
Nothing. Third and short. That's great effort from that Ole Miss defense. They've been torched a lot. They're playing right here into the, you know, into the fourth quarter and playing tough. I wonder if they're going to go. I see Bolden, Slade Bolden coming out of the game. I wonder if they're going to go Wildcat with Bolden. Holden was a high school quarterback for 18 right there. That's the Wildcat quarterback.
Fourth down at a yard. Holden in there.
Yep, two is at wide receiver.
He's going to fake it to Smith, and he's going to get the first down. He was in there a few plays ago in a different spot. This time he takes the direct snap, gets first down.
Brad Slade Bolton is a four-star recruit from Louisiana. In high school, he passed for 1,600 yards, ran for 1,400 yards. Legitimate athlete, well, could also play baseball for Alabama. So watch that number eight. You know, I wonder if he's Nick Saban's Hunter Renfrow. You know, he couldn't stop him. Can't stop him. Yeah, go sign him. Yeah. Join him, right?
First down. Mechie in motion that time. Handoff is to Najee Harris. Broke one tackle. A great move in the open field. A stiff arm. It blasts down to the 21-yard line.
You know who Najee Harris is. You watch inside that offensive line. Still in the game. Oh, nice cut that time.
I guess two of them.
Set it up and just came back right behind it. Ran right behind the cut of Chris Owens, the block of Chris Owens, number 79. You know what he reminds me a little bit of, the way he catches the ball in the backfield, is Le'Veon Bell. A little patient runner, catch the ball, physical when he has it.
Throw out to Judy, put his hands up there, and somehow made that catch. It looked like that ball was going to go to the sideline, and he snatched it, dropped it out of bounds, short game. So Alabama with 9:18 to go, driving again. Fourth quarter passing. He has had to play in fourth quarter this season. Last season it took, what, to the ninth week, Gary? You had a guess on that. How long did it going to take?
I think it was already the ninth. We were wondering, was he even going to throw one before we saw him at late in the season? I think this is good for him and the football team.
Of course, his numbers last year were off the charts, and everybody couldn't stop talking about him. Now his numbers are even better, and it seems like he's doing it quietly. Five touchdown passes today, one on the ground.
He slid. Absolutely. We asked him if he's ever slid before, and he goes, no, don't know how to slide.
Didn't
right?
play baseball. Right. He said we've been working on it, though. He did a pretty good job of it here.
Yeah, and there are times when you got to think about the team and just give yourself up and line up on, you know, give yourself another third down throw. As well as he throws the ball, you do not want to take unnecessary hits. He, obviously, if Alabama's going to win the national championship, which is how they measure success here, has to stay healthy.
That is crazy.
And 14 incompletes, is that right?
Yeah, so 10 touchdowns.
10 touchdowns.
Third down and eight. Tua loads it again. Throw is complete. His tight end giving him some sugar. Touchdown. Miller Forrestal.
What a beautifully designed route this time. You get the crisscross of the receivers, and that's what makes it go. Inside, outside, split them right in between. Watch this. Outside, inside, stop right in between. Wow, well designed. Give a lot of credit to Steve Sarkisian. That is an NFL play right there.
Bullivus in for the point after. Point number 59 for Alabama is up and good. Just under 8 minutes remaining in the ball game. A 75-yard march in 11 plays. And for the sixth time today, a touchdown pass off the left arm of Tua Tagovailoa. Just under 8 minutes left. Most touchdown passes in school history. Tua has just tied A.J. McCarron in that capacity. He's got another record we'll tell you about in a second. It's a day of records for he and Devontae Smith. The six touchdowns through the air and one on the ground gives him seven for the day. That breaks his own record. So sometimes it's just nice if you break your own record and then nobody else is mad at you. But when you talk about game changers, let's take a look at the GMC game changer today. If you can have a better outing than number six, I don't know. This is how the game started. First touchdown 75 yards for Alabama, 74 yards, and then Tua just kept going in that same vicinity. Where's number six? Crossing route. I don't know how he stayed in bounds and didn't go down on that one.
Notice Henry Ruggs down there blocking. He was going to say, hey, guys, you pointed out Smith and Judy. How about pointing out me? So we wanted to show him getting that block on that touchdown.
Here's Jerrion Ealy trying to fight for an extra yard or so. There's Devontae. And the numbers today, staggering. 274. Amari Cooper had the two best, as he had tied himself in the 2014 season. And Amari, not sure what the Cowboys going on. Man, that was one of my records. But you knew one of those receivers. Maybe you weren't guessing Devontae Smith would be the guy to break it, but quite a day.
Well, Tua may get a rest, and the receivers may get a rest, but the defense isn't earning a rest. Sertan's still out there. Diggs is out there. Job is out there. I mean, they got all their starters on defense still out on the field. Cahill's playing at inside linebacker now, number 10.
Shane Lee, the freshman, still in there, the other inside linebacker position.
Xavier McKinney's going to make a stop right there.
Yeah. McKinney combines on the stop with Cahill, who had a touchdown on a blocked punt earlier in this half. And now Alabama trying to change up some personnel as Sertan has to hustle to get to the sideline before the snap. On the ground they stay with Ealy's all wrapped up, dropped after a short game by Musika, the nose tackle. Monday, everyone's back in the neighborhood. Cedric the Entertainer and Max Greenfield start a new episode of the hit comedy Monday at 8, 7 Central on CBS. Third down upcoming, third and six at the 6-minute mark of the ball game. John Rhys Plumlee, his first start. He's played admirably. Had that one knocked down by Ben Davis. But he's over 100 yards through the air and on the ground.
Talk Ole Miss just a little bit. Matt Luke had his team a couple of games that were coin flip games that he needed. The Memphis game and the Cal game, both winnable games, did not come up. Vanderbilt next week. Can his team play like this on offense, step up the defense a bit, and win the game they're supposed to win next week? That is the measurement that Matt Luke has to talk to his team. We showed up. They're good, guys. We get it. Let's see what we can do next week against Vandy.
Fourth down. Toss down the middle is intercepted. Jared Maiden coming the other way for Alabama. And all the way back to the 49-yard line. First interception of the year for Jared.
Made way over to the right side. No chance Plumlee even anywhere near to see on the safety. Put it up for grabs like that. Maiden, an experienced player, eats it up.
Tua Tagovailoa can take a towel. His day is done, and it was a brilliant day. Six touchdown passes and one on the ground, accounting for seven total touchdowns today. That means our scholar athlete that we told you about earlier, Mac Jones, in at quarterback. Keelan Robinson, the freshman tailback, will be behind him, as Alabama with a 59-24 lead has gone to some of their backup guys, including Keelan Robinson, who goes for about 8 yards on his first carry.
Well, Ness, one of their backups is Deontay Brown, who's trying to earn his way back into the starting lineup. Watch him pull and deliver the punch that he does. Ooh. Just to the end. Oh, my goodness.
He knocked Kadir Shepherd about four yards backwards.
When I saw it first, I didn't realize it would. That was a major punch to the outside. He's a big old horse, isn't he?
He is. 338 pounds. Well, he might be a little bigger than that right now, because he's still working his way back into shape.
Emma did a good job of taking the whole play clock, running the ball now.
And a good run again. Nice hit at the end of that. We talked about 3 hours ago about not only is Alabama good, but the SEC is pretty good. Alabama 4-0, Georgia 4-0, LSU 4-0, Auburn 4-0, and Florida just went to 5-0. So five SEC teams in the top 10. Something's got to happen somewhere, partner.
You know, it's interesting for Florida. Everybody said, yeah, they haven't played anybody yet. You know, Florida goes, wait, hold on here. We beat Tennessee and Miami? The old days, that would be like, let's have a parade, you know? And that's not beating anybody anymore. And remember, they still have to play Florida State, you know, so, and they probably won't get any credit for that either, you know?
There's LSU scheduled. Look at that. 9-7-2-23.
It's going to be fun to watch CBS SEC football here the rest of the year. We are going to have some battles.
We'll be at Florida next week. LSU, Georgia, Alabama for Auburn.
Yeah, every one of them.
Everybody's got to play everybody pretty much.
You know, not only for Florida, kind of is funny, is, you know, they play Florida State and Miami out of conference, and their crossovers, they get LSU and Auburn.
Wow.
How about that?
That's crazy. Now to the final 3.5 minutes here, as Alabama will be celebrating their 29th straight home win. It'll be 50 of the last 52 they've won here.
So we got a chance to watch Georgia up close last week against a good Notre Dame team. Now watching Alabama. Those are the two heavyweights right now, right? I mean, everybody's measuring it against those two guys in this league.
And they're measuring up pretty well right now.
Right
the other
now,
three
yeah,
we just talked about.
Exactly.
Well, it's always kind of fun to be part of records, and we saw them dropping like flies today in Tuscaloosa between Tua and Devontae Smith.
Mac Jones just took a snap from under center. He almost didn't know what to do after. Say what? To catch it under his leg. What am I supposed to do? I mean, I got to stick my hands in there. I mean, wait, what? And catch
I don't even
ball?
Know Darian Delcourt that well. He's a freshman.
You know, my center for the Detroit Lions was the next Alabama player, Steve Mott.
Oh, I remember
yeah,
him. Yeah,
Stevie.
Fourth down at 4. See if Mac puts one up here. He will, and it's on target. Oh, and it's dropped yep. by Mechie. That'll turn it back over to Ole Miss.
Nice delivery, put it exactly on target. Mechie turned just a little bit.
BJ will have scores and highlights of the college football postgame show presented by Rocket Mortgage as Ole Miss comes out to take the field here in the final 2 minutes and 17 seconds. Scored 24 points today, which isn't bad against Alabama, but it's not going to be nearly enough. Grant Tisdale's in at quarterback now, another true freshman. He has not thrown a pass this year.
Rich Rod was telling us his quarterback room is led by redshirt freshman Matt Corral, and all the rest are true freshmen.
Yep.
All four true freshmen.
He says he gets nervous in that meeting room just thinking about the youth out there. The lady that drove me downtown last night, Carrie, was telling me a story that she and her husband moved from the Midwest to Tuscaloosa just so their daughter could go to school here. She wanted to go to school since the time she was born. She was born at halftime of the 2000 Orange Bowl, and she still can't stand Tom Brady. And Tom Brady in that game, and I did it,
yep.
threw 3 touchdown passes to David Terrell. It's probably until this last Super Bowl the last time Brady wasn't the MVP of some big game. And I was thinking about David Terrell yesterday when I was thinking about her daughter having to go, wanting to go to school here and loving Alabama that much that they would move the whole family down here. Well, I thought that was a good wide receiver performance. Devontae Smith's got a better one today.
Today, you got it right. I mean, you got Brady throwing to him, you got chances, now you got Tua throwing to you.
Third down, a long 2 for Tisdale. And he's not going to get it. It'll be fourth down. Cahill again, the linebacker who scored on a blocked punt earlier with the tackle. spreads the wealth even more than he did today, but it just happened to be number six's day. Devontae Smith on the receiving end of five of those, and then the tight end got the last one. Fourth and one, might be the last touch Ole Miss gets as Alabama stops him. And he's going to get the first down. So got his feet wet, as they've done most of the day with a quarterback run.
Yeah, Brad, I got up there. I went to get something to eat. I sat right next to Eli Gold. I said, does it ever get old? He says, no, not on a CBS game, because I'm nervous the whole game because I don't know which one of your calls you're going to take. So I got to make sure all my calls are good, because I know one of the touchdowns is going to end up on CBS.
Well, yeah, he's called a lot of touchdowns for a lot of years and will be the recipient of the National Football Foundation Chris Schenkel Award coming up when we go to the dinner in New York City the first week of December. Tisdale, long sideline, nice adjustment by his wide receiver. Dennis Jackson with the catch.
Throw it up. Football.
2012 to about now, you see it almost every game. Five or six things, don't you?
Yeah, for sure.
I think Mike Evans got, I know it's been done before, but I just, the guy that for me that changed it was Mike Evans.
Here's a long ball to the end zone and a touchdown
throw.
Jaden Jackson, Tisdale, with a touchdown throw, 28 yards.
Yeah, that was perfect.
Been a long time since Alabama's given up 31 points, I'm sure.
And except Davis, number 22, is in phase for a while. Then right at the end, Jackson kind of extends his arm and kind of separates, but the ball was perfect from Tisdale.
With 5 seconds left. And you know that Nick Saban will go back to practice and say, all right, I gave you guys a chance to play. You back up players and you give up a touchdown.
I think he may phrase it a little different.
No, I think he might too, but there's a teaching tool there somewhere.
I know. May look a little bit and sound a little different than that. You were very, very calm.
That was a beauty, though.
He says it. What did he, I think he told us that, you know, when I coach some of the young guys, the linebackers, they're not used to me. The DBs are used to me.
They're used to my voice.
Exactly.
So they'll hear his voice again at practice. But you got to think that Ole Miss never gave in. Boy, that's,
yeah,
it's hard
so
to play when you're down that big.
It's going to take time. That's all there is to it. You've got to build it step by step. They brought in a lot of young talent, and now they got to fill it out. You know, for me, the key, I think they're going to find offense eventually. To me, Mike McIntyre, the defense, can they get back to being that land shark defense?
Right. Yep.
Because I know it's an offensive game in modern football, but you've got to be able to slow them down and get them off the field three, four, five times a game, or you just, it just gets too long in the game.
Even with the short field after the muff punt and taking the lead 10-7, it was all Alabama after that until this fourth quarter, where Ole Miss got a couple of extra scores. Makes it look probably a little different if you hadn't watched the game score-wise than what really happened here today. And Forrestall makes the catch, takes a knee, and we'll have to have one more snap. So a 90-point game here in Tuscaloosa today. Jones will come out.
I just get the feeling when you turn on the tape as a defensive coordinator against Alabama and you go, all right, where do we start?
Yeah.
Where do we start?
And there's where we end. The knee by Jones. And Alabama and Nick Saban's team goes to 5-0 with a week off coming. But that was the star right there. Steve Sarkisian puts his arm around number six. He was nothing short of sensational today. That guy was pretty good, too. Let's check in with Jamie and Nick.
Coach, Tua, Devontae Smith, a remarkable day for them. What kind of statement did your offense just make as you head into a break in the season?
Well, you know, I think we're very productive on offense today. We had some opportunities that we missed, but, you know, those two guys were fabulous in the game. So, you know, we obviously didn't play very well in defense, so we need to fix that. But, you know, the quarterback did a really good job for him. He could run and, you know, gave us a lot of problems.
And a big picture perspective, how important is it that Tua is getting snaps late in the fourth quarter?
Well, I don't know that that's all that important. I think he's got plenty of experience. I think it's more important that we get other guys' experience, just like we did at the end of the game with putting both second teams in.
All right, Coach, thanks. All right,
thank you.
Devontae, your name jumped above names like Amari Cooper today in the record books. What did this day feel like for you from a wide receiver position?
I'm just out there executing the game plan that Coach called. It could have been anyone else in that position. It just happened to be me today.
When you're catching balls from Tua, does it make you smile how easy it makes your job sometimes?
It's a blessing.
Did you practice rock, paper, scissors this week? Because you seem to win a lot today.
No more rock, paper, scissors, no more.
All right, congratulations.
Appreciate it.
I think that edict has come down, don't you think?
I think, yeah, that's the end of that game.
Exactly.
You and I could play it up here, but I don't think they're going to play it anymore.
I don't think
down
that
there
would.
All right, it's time for our plays of the game presented by Jersey Mike's Subs. And one of 11 catches. This was the first one for Devontae Smith. And he takes it 74 yards for the opening touchdown for Alabama. And then he says, well, let's do it on a crossing route. Thank you, Tua. And you two guys, you didn't get me, and my balance kept me upright, and it got me to the pylon. There's number two. Here comes a quick toss, a block by his teammate Jerry Jeudy, and down the sideline it goes for number three. Tua scans the field. Gonna go deep. Guess what? Beautiful catch. Acrobatic catch in the end zone for number four. And here was the capper. And the last one, just as pretty as number four. 11 catches, 274 yards, and 5 touchdowns.
Eli has it in his contract. He can only do one. So it came to you. You had to do the 5.
I had to do them all.
Exactly.
Well, 59-31 is the final. That's going to wrap it up for us. For Gary and Jamie, Brad Nessler saying so long from Tuscaloosa. Final score, the unbeaten and second-ranked Crimson Tide. Will they be number one when the new AP poll comes out? Well, they do it in resounding fashion. 59-21 is the final. College football postgame show presented by Rocket Mortgages is coming up after these messages. Join us next week. Another top 10 matchup will be in the swamp. 3:30 Eastern time next Saturday on CBS Sports. So long from Brian Denny.